Hey everyone, Slayer here to introduce Nasty and Friends from BDC Studios, a podcast where two friends who met in the Army Reserves get together and talk about shit. One's a firefighter and the other has a funny laugh. So sit back, get rid of your kids, and hold on to your b**ts, because it's about to get nasty, friends.
Welcome to Nasty and Friends, with Pack Nasty and Spicy Motherfucking Brown.
All right, you cock smokers. I know it's been a while. Sorry, I had to come with the heat to begin with. It's been a while. We're back at it. We got three of the baddest motherfuckers here. Yep. We're going deep. Before we get started, I do introductions, let you guys know what's going on. I want to give some shout outs because I have a feeling we're going to ride this bitch off the rails tonight. Yeah. So
this might be a 10-hour podcast, motherfucker.
Could be. Shouts out. Just want to make sure. I know you guys out there haven't forgot about him, but his name hasn't been said in a while. It's, you know, the pimp of all pimps out there, Biscuit Tits. Want to give a shout out to him.
Big shouts out, Biscuit Tits, man. If you're listening, it's all love.
Making sure he's still killing it. Couple other shout outs. My good friends, Rob and Ashley, they just had a baby. So it's a little baby boy. I'm not going to say his name. I'm sure they wouldn't mind, but we'll just call him Baby O. So, like, that's great. And I know all you motherfuckers out there remember that. That closet fucking sex freak Spencer, him and his girlfriend just had a baby girl. So we'll just call her Baby Q, but congratulations to them. So big shouts out there. That's awesome. So
yeah, well done, dude.
As my late father would say, good dick work, gentlemen.
good dick work indeed.
Yes. So let's set the scene for you. Our guest chose the video that's playing. It's not on YouTube. He changed it up, which is not bad because what he chose is fucking spectacular. We got the Chappelle Show Season 2 rolling on mute in the background. Spicy has the DVDs. It's fucking great. Sitting across from me, as always, is the fucking great, handsome, bearded son of a bitch tonight, which is fucking looking good, man. Looks good. I don't see you in a beard very often.
Hey,
so.
Hey, thanks, man. I'm on furlough. I'm on vacation. So, My thing is, you know, I'll shave when I have to. If I don't have to, I'm not going to shave.
Yeah,
so I think my beard's a little over 2 weeks.
Yeah, looks
I got
good.
Almost another week to grow it. I'm getting compliments, and it's nice, man. So, hey, thank you.
Yep. And then the person sitting to my right, oh, Jesus, I've known him since, when did you get to fire school?
2006.
It was 2006. Like, I got there in April of 2006.
May of 2006.
So it was May. So we've known each other since May of 2006. Unfortunately for him, he was not in the 245th like us, but he did drill in the 516th. He was in, you remember that crazy fuck that broke the chair, Rob Long?
Yeah, I know.
He was in his unit. So, he's one of my favorite people. He's fucking funny shit. He's definitely my favorite person to get racist with. So let me introduce you. We got Daddy Fat Sacks, a.k.a. Skywalker 101, a.k.a. Puerto Rican of my dreams, a.k.a. Danny, don't leave your girl around in Molina.
Hey, I'm not surprised, motherfuckers.
Hey, I want to add AKA the Puerto Rican zombie.
Oh yeah, there you go.
I just made that up. That's not even real. We're gonna make it real, ladies and gentlemen.
But appreciate you coming on, man. Like you, we've been wanting you on for a while. Glad we could work it out with the schedule and shit like that. So it's gonna be a good time.
Yeah, I'm a long-time listener, first-time podcaster.
That's awesome.
I'm happy to be here. Before we get all funny and shit, just want to say thanks for having me.
Yeah.
This is dope what you guys have. Like, this is a great fucking idea to have all the Army guys, you know, for people out there listening. There was like a group of us that really kind of got in the unit right around the same time. There was a good like 10 of us, you know, Peg Nasty, Long,
mm-hmm. Harris.
Harris, all those guys, Condesa. Spicy,
yeah.
You know, Condesa. Myself, Wilburn.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, we all kind of grew up together because we're all like young adults. And so for us to have this to fall back on and listen to is awesome. Because we, you know, we're all doing our own separate things,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Most of us are out. Yeah, a good handful of
exactly,
us.
Exactly. Yep. So. You're living in Kansas City. Your life's over. Spicy's here living with two cats. He doesn't even know their fucking names. I don't know what the fuck's going on here.
Yeah.
He's ordering food and we're getting the wrong food. You know, like. It's good though. It's awesome. I love what you guys have. I listened like to the first five episodes. I got to get caught up. I'm pretty busy with what I got going on.
You're missing the two best episodes.
Yeah, so I'm excited. So, what I'll probably do is I'll probably buy the internet on the plane tomorrow. I'll probably listen to it on my way to California.
That's what ballers do, ladies. Yeah.
Baller, I'm just a baller doing baller type shit. You know, but that's what I do.
Yeah. So like I said, and I know a lot of people be like, "What do you mean? It's like his favorite person to get racist with." Like we say some of the most ridiculous shit to like make each other laugh. And like segue into that, like obviously, like most guests, you came bearing gifts.
Yes.
Fuck yeah.
Like, before we get to that, because that's good. That's good. But,
yeah.
No, Danny, I want to thank you for for being on. It's good to have you. Like for me, both of you guys are some of the funniest motherfuckers I know. So I know no matter what happens, I'm gonna have fun and I'm gonna laugh my fucking ass off.
Yeah.
And yeah, indeed, it is good to bring it all again. A lot of us stay in touch. You know. I'll see dudes. I still see Foxy once a week. I see Whiny.
You mean fucking, fucks?
Fucks. You mean fucks? I call him the good fox because we had that lieutenant.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
What was he, 12?
He was a piece of shit. Can you're listening, can fuck. Can you so, Josh Fox is still my dude.
Yeah.
He used to be my roommate. Yeah, I see him all the time. Fucking Wilburn stopped by.
Yeah, he came. It was the first night we recorded second night or something like that. He came over. There. We listened to the podcast, and he brought us little shooters.
Yeah.
Just fucking awesome. So.
Yeah.
Shout out to him. He just had a little baby boy,
shout
too.
Shout out to Wilburn. Yeah, they had everybody's making babies around this month.
Hey, Wilburn, if you're listening to this, what's up, dog? You know you're at, fool?
That's our favorite scene from Training Day, by the way.
Our end bomb, Whiny, who's on the department with me. I see him every now and then. He came out to do trivia with us. We still see a lot of the Army guys. There's some we don't see. There's some I see. Because fuck it, in our period of being in or out, there's been a lot of guys. Some guys came for 4 years, got out, and we try to stay in contact with each other. And yeah, it is a good thing, and we have a blast. And hey, thanks for coming, dog.
Yeah, so. Pag Nasty, we were talking earlier before we started. I moved my flight back.
Yeah,
to do this, I had family pictures I got to take with my family back in California.
Yeah,
and I used different excuse.
I've done that. I've done that before. I've falsified
because I don't want to miss this day.
No, right, you know? Right. It's an honor.
So I, you know, that's just one of those baller type things.
It's another baller move, ladies and gentlemen. Get your notepads out. You're going to be getting some advice. You understand?
And pour yourself a banana cognac, bitch.
America don't want to see us work. They want to see us live.
No, we really appreciate it. You're going to be on here definitely multiple times. Like most, like everybody, everybody that's been on so far, we want to rotate through. We're going to get Spice and I were just talking. Like, I mean, we love what we have so far, but we need to get at least a female on here to like
we're gonna break
bird? It up. Y'all trying to get a bird in here?
But before we forget, let's jump into the gifts
that
you brought because like I said, he's one of my favorite people. Like, we'll just text some of the most racist shit.
Yeah.
And the reason why is because obviously you heard me say he's a Puerto Rican in my dreams. He's Puerto Rican, and obviously my background's Italian, and they fucking hated each other, you know, throughout history. So we give each other so much
shit.
We give each other so much shit about that. Mm-hmm. And so he came into the house. He's like, I'm just gonna go drop this shit off downstairs. We're like, what the fuck? Did you bring a bomb? Or like, what the hell? He's like trying to interrupt this Nasty and Friend shit that's going on. So, but I don't know if you want to tell like what you brought. It's
yeah. So I knew that a couple people brought gifts and stuff to the show. So I was telling Spicy a couple weeks ago. I'm doing some work from home and looking at my schedule, looking at my planner. I'm like, shit. I got that podcast. I just pushed it back. You know, I just pushed my trip back. I was like, I got to come with some heat for the show.
Yeah.
Spicy here is German and black. And I'm like, what's German and black that goes together? Well, nothing really, you know? So I was just like, first thing that came to mind when I thought of German was German chocolate cake.
Right.
And then the first thing that came to mind for black was chicken. So I brought this motherfucker a German chocolate cake with pieces of fried chicken.
Like in the fucking frosted, it's not frosted, but whatever that shit's on top, like smashed down.
Oh,
We'll put it up on the motherfucking gram later.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it's fucking, dude, I had tears. Yeah, I was fucking laughing so hard.
Indeed, one of the best gifts I've ever had. It's fun because it's just a great, it's thoughtful.
Yeah.
It looks delicious. And it's racist as fuck. Racist as fuck, dude. So I love it, man. Thanks, Danny. We will upload it onto the motherfucking gram so you can see we're talking about German chocolate cake.
I have a name for it,
fried chicken.
I have a name for it.
What is it?
Jerome Hitler.
Jesus.
Oh, is, that, is that too much?
Too soon? No. Too soon? No. Too soon? No. Not too soon.
Not soon enough.
And real quick, the motherfucker a few years ago on my birthday, motherfucker rolled through my crib. Brought one of those big ass gourmet cookies you could get, and he had somebody write on the cookie "scumbag" in big letters. So I knew he would probably bring some heat. He's a good gift giver. I'm what a good can gift I say? Giver.
Yeah. That's what I do, man. And then for my boy Pagnassi over here, I got him a lifetime supply of spaghetti sauce. Yeah, three cans is a lifetime supply.
It's so, true. It's true. And the best part is they're three different flavors.
Three different
flavors,
there
was thought put into it.
Yeah, mix it up, man. Yeah. You want to go traditional one night? You want to go garlic and onions another? You have that opportunity. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You saved you a trip to the store. You don't have to get lost in Kent. Wherever you live now. I don't know where you live now.
So,
Timbuktu, wherever you live.
Yeah. So that reminds me of you told me this story years ago about your grandma.
Yeah.
And then you and then your grandma passed away, and then you told a story was it her funeral?
Yeah,
was it at the wake or whatever
the fuck
it's called?
Well, the story is
I
love this. So the story is I was really close to my grandmother. Very, very close. One most hardest working person I've ever met in my life. And I attribute everything I do in my life to her and my hard work with my field, whatever.
She must be disappointed.
Very disappointed. Dude. She's fucking shaking her head, dude. She's drunk right now.
Lucky.
But she had this meal she would make me. It's called entomatadas, right? Which in Spanish, I don't know what it means.
Like, you know what
I don't
speak
know what it
Spanish.
Means. Yeah, I say it really good, but I don't know what the fuck it means. But I know it's like an enchilada, right?
Uh-huh.
Well, I know there's a certain white cheese she used, and so. Sometimes you just get cravings, and I was craving it, so I was like, fuck, I'm going to go to the store, I'm going to get everything to make and throw my thoughts. I don't know what it is, I just know how to make it. So I'm at the grocery store, and I knew the cheese she used started with an M. I don't know if it was Monterey Jack or mozzarella.
Okay.
So the best thing about my grandmother is, no matter what time of the day it is, if you called her, she'd pick up the phone.
Right.
So just the way grandma should, you know?
Yeah.
So I call her, and I'm like, I call my grandma, Ma. I'm like, Ma. She's like, what's up? I go, I'm at the grocery store trying to make throw my thoughts. I don't know what cheese to use. I know you use a cheese that starts with an M. I don't know if it's Monterey Jack or mozzarella. She goes, mozzarella? We're not fucking Italian. Oh, dude, I was dying. As soon as she said that shit, I was like, I'm about to kill Mario.
He was like dying laughing. Because I remember answering the phone, and I'm like, are you all right? He's like, I got to catch my breath, dude. He's like, I'm fucking laughing. Just give me a moment.
Right.
He's like, I just talked to my grandma, and I'm like, grandma dropped some heat? Like, well, what's going on?
You know, she passed away earlier this year, or last year, and we're all just, you know, storytelling, this and that. And with some people I haven't seen in a long time since I was a kid. And they're all telling like stories of like my grandma freaking, you know, giving them rides, giving them advice, lending them money, like, you know, on their last string, whatever. And here I go, y'all want to hear a better story? About some fucking mozzarella?
I told them they were dying.
Because like my grandma really never cursed or anything.
Right.
You know, so it was just funny that like, I just changed like the tone, you know, because it's the funeral. People are sad,
right,
this and that,
obviously.
You know. So, but rest in peace, Grandma. You're probably looking down. This is water, by the way.
We ain't fucking Italian. I'll just get a random text from him that'll say that. It'll be like 3:30 in the morning.
I'll be wasted, dude. I'll be wasted, and I'll see like a Fazoli's commercial. Like, I gotta text Marty.
And it's just like shit like that. Like I remember after Meston's, I think it was his baby shower, you guys came over to the to our duplex when JPEG and I lived in.
Yes, that Ron Jeremy wine.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah. And so we were we had some drinks or whatever, and you had to bounce back to your hometown. And so I like gave you a hug as what we normally do, and then I just fucking just start like patting you down. I'm like, what the fuck are you doing? I'm like, make sure you didn't steal anything. He's like, you motherfucker.
You missing anything?
Just shit like that. Yeah. Like it's one of my favorite things. I love it. It cracks me up. So
sure, that's fucking great. Great.
Whack Arnold's.
What's that? Oh, yeah.
That's like my favorite skit.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
Hey, Calvin got himself a job. Way to go, young blood. Way to go.
It's good. If you've never seen it, I don't know where the fuck you've been. Like, after you get done watching It's Always Sunny, watch the Chappelle Show.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. If you haven't watched the Chappelle Show, fix your fucking life. For real.
It's so fucking funny.
It's still funny now.
Like, where can you get it? Yeah. I mean, besides, it's not on, like, Netflix or anything like that.
You know, they have some episodes on YouTube. You might have to just... I don't know if it's on Comedy Central. I got the DVD, the first two seasons on DVD.
Yeah.
It's fucking great, man. He's a fucking genius.
Yeah, I just saw him.
Stand-up's great.
He was in Lincoln a couple years ago. It was great. Mm.
Yeah, he still fucking slings, man. Mm-hmm. He still goes to the Comedy Store and fucking drops ripped. I want him to fucking do a new hour, but...
Yeah, he's ripped. That dude's like...
Is he?
Yeah, dude's shredded.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Speaking of comedy, you worked Amy Schumer. She was around here. I texted you and you said you weren't, like, it wasn't that great.
No, you know, yeah, I worked at the arena. I guess I worked part-time as an EMT down there, which is, fuck, it's a great gig.
That's gotta be one of the best.
Yeah.
It's decent money. It's not working for the city. It's working for a company. So it's just a part-time gig. But even if the event is shit, people watching is usually amazing. Oh. On top of that, yeah, I get to see concerts and I get to see
bird watching,
all sorts of shit. Bird watching. Amy Schumer, I worked less than a week ago, and I was pretty pumped. You know, she's great on stand up.
Yes.
Trainwrecked was great. Her show on Comedy Central was great. I wasn't, you know, I wasn't impressed.
Right.
I
mean, it's got to be hard because she just released the HBO Hour special that just came out. This is her fourth season of Inside Amy Schumer. She probably doesn't have
a lot of material.
I mean, she has plenty of material, but like to fine tune it. You know what I mean? To do arenas like that.
And we got big. We had a patient. Patient was bad. We had to call for a medic. But the person that opened for her, I can't remember her name. I didn't see her. She did 15 minutes. Her show came out that night on Comedy Central called Only Whores Wear Purple. I can't think of her name.
Oh, I'm not sure.
Should have did some research. I didn't know this was going to come up. But it's a good comedian. She's good. I'm just drawing a blank.
I got to stop wearing purple.
Yeah, you do. Yeah. No, rest in peace, Prince.
Yeah, R.I.P. Prince, dude.
But so anyway, we had a patient. So I came in late into the show. But I didn't think it was good. I do think it is harder to do comedy in a giant venue with, I think it was like 11, 12,000 people there versus a small comedy club. Because the last one I saw before that was Bert Kreischer, and he killed it. Compared to that,
yeah, because we talked about.
I don't think I don't think Amy Schumer is that strong of a comedian either. I mean, you know what I mean? I think no disrespect.
No,
Amy. Amy.
Who you fucking, OJ?
No, but there's just solid fucking stand-up comedians. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And maybe in a room she would have killed it, but just on stage.
She could have just talking, had an off night, too.
I just don't think. She's young.
Yeah.
She's doing movies. She's doing TV. She's not working on stand-up all the time.
Right.
Two of the bits that she told and she ended with were shit I heard before. The bit, she's got a bit about meeting Hillary Clinton at a birthday party.
Yeah.
She's got a bit about meeting Bradley Cooper, and they're kind of funny, but I'm like, that's not that funny. I know funny, motherfucker. It's okay.
Hillary Rodham.
You're sending, but at the same time, she's smart. She's got movies. She's hot right now. So
yeah, she's hot.
You're going to sell fucking arena tickets.
Oh, yeah.
So, I mean, I think that's what, you know. I've seen comedy before, and I'm dying laughing. That's what it should be there. People are just like watching it, like, it's too bad. It's pretty good. It's too bad. You know.
But whatever. I mean,
but you're making money. You strike when the iron's hot.
Exactly. Right.
You
know.
Yeah. And I think she'll get better.
She'll get better.
Right. It could have just been a bad set.
She's young. She'll get better. Yeah. But if she focuses on stand up, she's a movie star.
Yeah, and then
most stand up comedians are not movie stars.
Amy Schumer, if you're listening to this, stay thick, mama.
Yeah, we're not. We're definitely not hating on.
No.
Nope. Shouts out Amy Schumer. Shouts out Ashley Graham. Shouts out to the thick ladies out there. Yeah.
We've been tweeting the shit out of Ashley Graham trying to get her on this podcast. Yeah, man. So.
Thicker than a bowl of oatmeal.
Yeah.
I love that. If you guys have not seen it, what he just quoted was, it's a video of a guy who's getting...
He's about to get sentenced.
Yeah, he's in court.
He's in the orange jumpsuit.
He's
in the orange jumpsuit. This motherfucker's got chains on his hand, and the defense attorney is talking about how when he got brought up to court, how he was looking at one of the guards. And when he was looking at one of the guards, he looked at her and said, damn, girl, you're thicker than a bowl of oatmeal.
So she quoted that.
She quoted him, and she looked over at him.
And then the camera pans over to him.
And he goes, he points and goes, yep.
With two hands, both hands.
Both hands. Yeah, like points this. At the defense attorney and just pretty much says, yep, that's dead. Yep. And then they interview him after.
Yeah.
And then the lady that's interviewing goes, thicker than a bowl of oatmeal? And he goes, hey, she had a fat ass.
You should look up the video.
Shit. Hashtag search thicker than a ball up on Instagram. The video will come up.
Yeah, yeah, it's good.
And when he points with his hands, it's the double pistol. Shooter McGavin style.
It's good. It's like the cocky look that he had. Because you know, it's like, I'm not going to deny it. That's a great lie. Yeah.
Speaking of Shooter, that video is probably the best thing since I've seen fucking Gilmore hit that hole in one on the par four.
I think I've said this on the podcast before, but I love that movie anyway. Yeah. But because of that fake Twitter account, the Shooter McGavin Twitter account,
God, one of my favorites.
He is become my favorite character in that. Like, I used to not like him, and he was funny, but because of that, he's my favorite part of that movie.
They're like,
back to your shanties.
That Twitter, that's one of my favorite ones. My other one is Pimp Bill Clinton. Yeah. I think right now it's Netflix and Bill. He always changes it.
The racial
It was Shmurda Clinton for a while. He keeps it fresh. But Clinton, fake Bill Clinton, and fake Shooter McGavin, one of the best accounts.
But like the thing is with the Shooter McGavin, a lot of people complain that he repeats all the same lines and the same jokes. It never gets old for me.
No, never gets old.
Hey, speaking of Shmurda, Bobby Shmurda, if you're listening to this, I know you're not because you're in prison. Put some money on your books. Watch your bunghole, man. and then a piece of advice, I probably want to make a song about killing people after you really did kill people.
That's not probably smart, sound right? advice. It's you know? Smart,
Bobby Shmurda, listen up, man. Yep. Jesus, dude. Yep. If you would have started listening to the podcast before you started doing all that shit, you'd be in a better place.
You'd start listening about a week ago.
A week ago.
Fucking son of a bitch.
Son of a bitch. You and Whiny with the puns. They're the best.
That's and we just had a pun earlier. Spicy came in talking about his thermostat was broke. I was like, yeah. That ain't cool.
That was great.
It's good.
That was great.
It's good. Puns are good.
That was another Whiny shout out. Shouts out Whiny. Whiny and Chappelle Show quotes. Motherfucker's good. He does great Chappelle.
Impression. Good.
We'll get him on too. It's a little bit harder with his shift because he's like opposite.
He works out. He works on the same department as me. We work opposite shifts. So I don't see him that much. It's all love though. Paige, shouts out.
He put in a good word for me apparently.
Yeah?
Yeah, I was talking to some bird. A while back, this was a long time ago.
Yeah. Shit's changed.
Like, I know Whiny, and I was like, oh, then that bird saw Whiny, and was like, oh, it's a good dude, blah blah blah. I'm like,
that's good. No, he's a good guy. Like, he is probably if. I don't know, I don't have his permission to give this out, so I'm not going to give out his Snapchat name.
I'll do it.
But he is my he's my favorite Snap person. He's my favorite Snapchatter that I have because all the fucking, like, with the empty beer cans and, like, the shooting bottles. Oh, when he went to Mexico, dude, I couldn't fucking wait to get to his Snapchat. Oh, yeah. They're so funny. He was just taking full fucking... the little champagne flutes, plastic flutes, and he just had the shower going, and he like raise it up full, and he just fucking throw one. He did four or five in a row, which you wouldn't think it doesn't fucking sound that funny, but he's my favorite Snapchatter out there. He's good. So him and then Dane Peterson is fucking pretty when he does Dane's Kitchen. I liked it so much, I put it out on Facebook for people to go.
I love Dane.
He hasn't done Dane's Kitchen in a while, but it's fucking hilarious. So
I got another story about Whiny. About somebody not vouching for him. Sorry, dude. So I'm in a bar, a local bar in Midtown.
The Max?
And, well done. And this is maybe a year ago. I see this chick. We start talking. I'm like, let's do some shots, you know?
Yeah.
So we start talking, and I was there for a party for another fireman. And she's like, are you a fireman? And I said, yeah. And she's like, my cousin's a fireman. I said, oh yeah, who's that? Like Whiny. I said, oh shit. I said, joking. I said, yo, that kid's a dick. And she's like, yeah. She's a fucking asshole.
Oh,
I said, hey, look. I said, Whiny.
I was kidding.
Yeah, I said, he's actually a good friend of mine. I've known him way before we got on the job together. We served together. Yeah. And she's like, yeah, well, we got problems, whatever. But
they could have worked it out. Maybe you brought him closer together.
Yeah, maybe I did. Either way, Shelly has some big old tits. So we took some shots, and then we talked about our boy. Kenny, and, he's a good dude. Dance. He's a good dude. Oh, great dude. You, oh, God, big old titties. But yeah, no, shouts out Whiny again for like the fourth time. Get on the show, motherfucker.
Yep.
But that's all.
No, it's awesome, man. So you guys got to talking about like some fucking funny ass stories. That a story you know that I don't know, but it's that vodka story.
Oh,
that's
all
was a vodka story.
Yeah. It's not that long of a story. It's just great. It's just like this is like spicy 101.
Okay.
So I don't remember the exact night it was, what we were doing if we were celebrating. It may have been like a drill weekend or something. All
right.
But we're all out drinking, and we go to Randy's.
Okay.
You know,
when
we were all going to Randy's.
That was early drill.
This is like 07, 08.
Okay, I was going to say.
It was a long time ago. But Spicy was having differences with his bird at the moment. And so he came up to me and he's like, let's get the fuck out of here. Let's go to another bar. Let's go downtown. I think you had friends at a bar downtown.
Okay.
And I was like, cool, let's go. Like, I'm still sober.
Yeah.
I can drive. Let's do it. And he goes, all right, I'll be there in 2 minutes. Meet me in the door in 2 minutes. I'm like, cool. So I go to the door. You're faded. You were fucking lit, dude. You were lit.
All right.
And so you come up to me and you're like, come here. And I'm like, what? And you're like, come here. Get close. And so I'm like, trying to kiss me, like, what the fuck, dude? Like, so I get close to you, and this motherfucker shoves a Red Bull vodka glass, right, like glass like this, in my pocket, and goes, "This one's for the road." And I'm like, dude, I got vodka Red Bull all over my nuts, dude. Like, it spilled everywhere.
Oh my! Like, you're trying to walk, but there's no lid.
I'm like, dude, this dude's fucking lit, man. Yeah. And like,
you could walk in like Forrest Gump before the braces came off.
No, I was faded. I do remember that story.
Yeah.
People that know me, I like to take roadies with me.
Yeah.
I think it's stupid that you can't. Like, if you're a passenger in a vehicle, like it,
some states is legal.
Missouri. Yeah.
Except for
a couple of cities, there's no, you can't get an open container. Anybody can have one, besides the driver, smart.
I've taken open drinks in Walmart before. Like the neighbor Walmart down the street, I go down there at night, I'm doing shopping, and I'm like, I got an orange cup, drinking vodka or whatever. Like, it's just, I like to drink, and I should be able to take it with me. Like, if I'm taking a road trip, or if I'm going to the store, if I'm driving, I should be able to take it.
Like, taking the fucking trash out.
Yeah, sorry, man. I didn't mean to spill it. That's funny.
That's fucking in your pocket. That's in great. I've never heard that story. Yep.
It was the funniest fucking thing ever. And this dude, hey, the best part about it, he goes, this one's for the road. And then he walks past me and leaves, and I'm standing there just thinking to myself, oh, my God. I got Red Bull vibes. The fuck's gonna happen? And I'm like, in the bed.
Right. Yeah. Absolutely.
Oh man.
Yeah. Whoa. That was great. That was awesome, man. Yeah. Those times are great.
And I'll take it back for people listening, especially the people, the Army brothers. Back then, 10 years ago, most of us that were drilling in Lincoln were from out of town.
Yeah.
And we would stay in town and we would go out. So we would do our fucking training. We would do our job. A lot of times on Sundays, fading. But we would all go out. Back then we had people that worked at different bars and shit. We would have a blast. Now, you know, the last few years, you know, people are married. People have kids. Even me, I'm like, fuck, I'm going home. If we get done early enough, I'm like, I'm just going to go home.
Right.
Special events, UFC fights, some shit, we would all stay out. Some of us would stay out, but it changed a lot in the last 10 years. But back then, shit was fucking crazy, man. And we had some rough drills, dude.
We had some hangovers. Ball, dude. Bad.
Fucking, that was great, man. We all came up together like that. It was
a lot of fun. Because I didn't really drink. I only drank twice before I turned 21. So then when I turned 21, I started drinking. So then, like, at drill weekends, it was like,
I remember.
Yeah, before that, you were on the heroin real hard.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, dude.
Real, the H. You're riding that fucking white girl. Yeah. But yeah, after that, I'm glad you kicked that and you started drinking when you turned 21.
You guys got me through it.
Yeah.
You know? I remember there was one time I was downtown, and you, like I said, you had, at Pagnassi, already turned 21, but he hadn't been drinking, like we were pre-21,
savages.
Savages. And so I remember running into him at a bar on the dance floor.
I look over and I'm like, oh shit, Pac Nasty. And he's like, dude.
He's faded. Yeah. He's faded. Yeah.
And it wasn't like, a drill weekend.
Yeah, so it was just a drill like weekend. It was just random. We ran into Lincoln on a dance floor and he was fucked up. And dude, I thought it was the funniest fucking thing. Because I'd never seen him really drink before, you know?
Yeah.
So that shit was just awesome. I was like, dude, this is the greatest fucking night ever. Because I remember waking up the next day and being like, that dude was fucked up. That was awesome, dude. That was fucking awesome, dude. Like, I never seen Pac Nasty like that. That was dope. The dude got faded.
So. Good. And I dance like a white guy, so it's just even better. Yeah. Don't give a shit. It's good times. No, it's a lot of fun, man. Going out with all the guys.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, sometimes you get fucking crazy. Or you get like the fucking attitudes and shit like that. But for the most part, I mean, we're all pretty. We've never really gotten into trouble
with other group of people. Like, no, I don't. You know, we always stay pretty level headed. You know,
right?
There was one time where.
Shout out to Rob
Long.
I got into it with somebody once.
Shout out to Rob Randy's and Long's little sister was there at the bar. She wasn't 21 yet.
Yeah.
And they're having a dance competition in front of the bar. And some dude pops out of nowhere and starts grinding all over Rob's sister. Rob's dad was there. All fucked up. This dude came up to the dude and like got in his face. And then Rob pushed his dad out the way and got in the dude's face. And Rob and the dude got in a big confrontation. The dude started like running around the bar talking about, you got more money than me. No, he said, I got more money than you. You ain't got more money than me. Just talking a bunch of gibberish. And I remember, I think it was Harris and somebody else were like pinning me down because I wanted to go fuck the dude up.
Right.
You know? And so Rob's dad grabs Harris and whoever the other person was and he pulls him off and he goes, he's protecting my goddamn daughter.
That's awesome.
I was like, it's my dude right there.
Yo, if somebody's getting into it, it's Long.
Harris
or whatever.
Yeah.
I do remember I went to a party in Lincoln, and I want to say it was a Vasco, a Big E, a.k.a. E Boogie. And I remember, I don't know if you guys remember this or where it was at even. This was years ago. I showed up. I brought gifts. It was all sex gifts, like lube and condoms and shit like that.
What are condoms?
That's a good question. So I remember some dude was beefing with Meston, and I didn't like it.
Yeah.
And I was like, what the fuck, man? He said something to me. I fucking pushed him.
Yeah.
I don't know if you guys were there.
No,
for that.
I don't remember. I would like, remember.
Jesus Christ, but
right.
I had to ask Long.
Yeah, because you probably got the most level head out of everybody.
Yeah, I'm pretty level headed.
Pretty fucking close. Yeah, so to see that.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Everybody's
this
like,
dude
yo.
Put a Red Bull vodka in my pants. Talking about fucking level headed, dude.
Right. Yeah, that's a little different.
No, but I don't, I'm not going to pop off unless, you know, shit's going downhill.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I thought. This dude was being serious. I guess he was fucking around. He said something to Meston, said something to me, and I was like, we could get down.
Dude is, dude.
Like, no, I'm good right now, man. If I start hitting that shit, it's just going to go downhill real quick. You know what I mean?
It's just a
but no, but it was. But no, we always have fun, and we. What are you coughing? So,
I smell like pine cones.
Every time I smell like pine cones, man, daddy be tripping.
I'm in the kitchen. You in the kitchen.
Goddamn refrigerator. So yeah, so like weekends would dwindle like down as far as everybody hanging out. But when we're on annual training and we're all in, you know, PA or Wisconsin or whatever, New York City, wherever we're at.
Yeah.
You can't fucking. You're out.
You can't pull a Denmark.
Yeah, it's happened. It's happened. You can be like, hey, I'm staying in the hotel. You can stay in the hotel, but more than likely you're going out. So we have adventures in different cities, and that's when it gets crazy.
That's when it gets nuts. Yeah. Talk about different cities. Talk about Manhattan, Kansas, there, bud.
That's when you're changing. We got aliases.
We
and
got
shit.
Yeah. It's a Friday, right? I'm still in college at the time.
All
right. This dude calls me. He's like, hey, I'm with this bird. We're going to Manhattan, Kansas. You want to roll?
I forgot about this. I only remember like one or two details. Right? So go ahead.
I'm like, fuck it. Let's do it. I just got paid. like $500. Thinking of a baller and shit, you know?
Yeah, absolutely.
So he picks me up. We head to Manhattan. Well, hey, do you remember what I was wearing? The shirt out? What the shirt said?
No.
I was wearing a shirt that said, fuck bitches, get money. And it had a pot of gold on the back.
Hashtag FBGM.
Right? So he picks me up, and we stop at the liquor store. I get a bottle of Hypnotic.
Of course you would.
Hell yeah.
Why wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Yep. At least I'd have to see a couple shots of Patron.
Yep. At least I have a fucking Red Bull vodka.
Yeah, right? It was in the back pocket.
Right. So he picks me up. I get the bottle of Hypnotic. We drive all the way down to Manhattan. It takes us like 2 hours. Remember we got stuck too? We got stuck in the mud.
We got stuck. Yeah, yeah.
So we get stuck in the mud. I finished the whole bottle of Hypnotic. Yeah. No joke. By, like,
it's
pretty
like 2%
much
alcohol. No.
Like the three sons. I drink the whole bottle by myself. Yeah. Like they had a few drinks, but I drank most of it.
Yeah, no, real quick. So on the way down, we had a cooler. I'm drinking, I think, Bud Light maybe. Danny's hitting the fucking Hypnotic.
Hard.
And he's hitting it hard.
Yep.
And even I'm like, Jesus. This is I'm like, well, yeah, fuck it, man.
Fuck it, yep, fuck it.
All right, so yeah, go ahead.
So we make it in Manhattan, and I'm already fucking lit. So we meet up Dispatch.
Dispatch. We met up with Dispatch.
This is pre-Dragon Days.
Yeah. Right.
This is when he was Dispatch.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we meet up with him. We go to his barbecue place, get some good grub.
Yep.
We go to a bar.
Yep.
And I think, and he brought a bird out.
He did.
And I remember the bird started talking to me, and I felt like he was like getting mad at me because she was like all like talking to me and stuff because I don't think she liked me. I just was like, you know, when I get when I'm drunk, I'm you know.
You're a fucking ladies man.
Yeah, you know, and I'm telling jokes, I'm whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
We started playing Big Buck Hunter.
Yeah, I remember. Yeah,
you had a headache. You had a headache.
I think so.
You had a headache
drinking that Bud Light.
He had a headache and he wasn't finishing his drink. So I was like, "Fucking, give me your drink, dude." Yeah, I started taking his drinks. Right.
Jesus.
We started playing Big Buck Hunter. I'm shooting everything on the fucking screen, and Dennis is or Spicy's like, "Dude, you're shooting the wrong fucking thing." And I'm like, "Do you remember what I said?"
Yes.
I said, "It's all beef."
Let's kill him. Doses
of shit, dude. Right?
Oh my god.
So then we go to another bar, and
did you make it to the shot bar?
Yeah, because
there was that shot bar with all the different shots written in. Okay, yeah, yeah.
We're sitting in the beer garden.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
And I'm like passed out on the fucking bench, like outside, and he's trying to wake me up, whatever.
Yeah,
and these girls come start cuts off.
Right. So all right. So for this scene, so like we go to Manhattan, Kansas to hook up with one of our friends, and so we get there, we're bar hopping, we eat, we're bar hopping. It's early. I don't know the exact time. I want to say it's like 9 o'clock. Some of the bars down there are connected. So I can't remember the names of it. I was stationed down there. I can't remember the names of it. But a few of the bars are connected. And one of the bars has an outdoor patio area with a ball court, bleachers, picnic tables. My man is passed out, head down on his hands.
Into his arms.
Into his arms at the picnic table. And I'm like, oh my God. Like, Danny, wake up, man. Come on, man. What do you need?
This
what can we do?
Embarrassing.
I got chicks. I'm like, hey, like, I'd see these pretty girls. It's a college town, K-State. It's not party town. It's no Iowa or Nebraska or whatever, but it's still a college town. So I'm seeing pretty girls. I'm like, hey, do me a favor. Wake my buddy up. Go over there. So pretty girls are coming over. Like, hey, Danny, come in. Like, rubbing on. He's out. He's done. He's done.
I'm just, nope.
So
Let me
tell this part of the story, man. And then you can tell it.
Yeah,
go ahead.
From
your blurry
point. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He knows it. He was sober as a bird that night. Yeah. So.
This is a story I forgot about until you started telling it, and I'm glad you did. It's fucking, it's gold. So Danny gets up, and he's like, I got to go to the bathroom. And I'm like, I'm going to follow him just because he's faded, you know.
Yeah.
So I go to the bathroom too. On the way into the bathroom, he bumps into this dude. And do you remember if the dude said something to you or not?
We bumped into each other, and then we looked at each other.
Mm-hmm.
And then I went to the urinal.
Yeah.
And I started peeing. And he followed me to the urinal.
Okay.
And he got close to me, like he's breathing down my neck. I remember that because we had bumped into each other.
Yeah. All right. So anyway. I don't know anything that's going on. I just know, next thing I know, Danny's squared off with this dude. And it's a college kid. Looks soft. White guy with these big glasses on.
Big black framed glasses.
And Danny says to him, I'm doing my own thing. And all I hear is Danny go, fuck you, buddy Holly. and he fucking pushes this motherfucker in the bathroom.
Fuck you, buddy.
I'm pretty sure my dick was still out.
Yeah. And I'm like, oh shit.
And so you know it's about to go down, but you're trying not to laugh because it's a fucking great line.
I'm like, and the dude didn't. I don't think he did shit. I think he just walked away. But I'm like, fuck. That's a good fucking line. It's a great line if you're sober.
Yeah.
Danny is fucked up. Dude, and to come out with that in the heat of the moment, like squirt off of some dude, I'm like, that's fucking gold.
That's fucking German chocolate cake and fried chicken on top of it, dude. You know what I'm saying?
Fuck you,
so bro. I'm laughing, but at the same time, if Buddy Holly wants a problem, he's got a fucking problem on his hands. He does not have a problem. Good decision for him. But, oh my God, that
was
great.
They take me back to the hotel.
You got a hotel room?
And it's like 10:30.
Yeah.
I'm passed out in the hotel by 10:30.
No. Yeah, No. He wasn't just passed out, ladies and gentlemen. As soon as we get into the room, I remember unlocking the room.
Yeah.
We're like, hey, we're going to go out. Hey, you know, we'll be back. I think the bar closing there is 2. I remember as soon as we opened the door, he's like, okay, goes to the bathroom, he's puking. So I'm like, all right, deuces. We go out, we bar hop till 2. We go to eat. There's some, I can't remember the name of the place. It's like a Denny's, but it's Bob's. Like a family.
Bob's.
Bob's? Okay.
Yeah, Bob's Diner. That's like the famous breakfast place.
Yeah, like 2:30, we're in there, we're eating good. Go back to the hotel room, he's out, he's sleeping. Great times. Next day, we hit up... we went to Fort Riley, did a tour. I told him some stories about
that was fun.
Yeah.
That was fun. Yeah, yeah.
It was good, man.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, that was cool. Yeah. Man, I was feeling like shit that next day.
Yeah, just one eye in the whole trip.
Yeah, and Molly's, or in the bird at the time was like, dude, your fucking face was green.
Yeah.
Like, you were so fucked up, your face was green. Yeah. And I was like, dude, I'm not... To this day, I don't think I've ever been that wasted.
You know, that shit happens, man.
It happens, you know? I've been wasted a lot since, you know? But I don't think I've ever been...
Like that. Have you had hypnotic sense?
No, I stopped. Seriously, yeah, I haven't really. Like,
I was wondering, and we've all done that. Like you know, and if you start out day drinking, like there's advance of shit. We do it. Once you get to that point, you're fucked. Like you can't. You can drink water, or whatever. You're done.
You're done, son. You're done for a long time.
You take a nap. You're gonna wake up feeling like shit. You either got to keep going and power through it. Or you're fucking done. We've all done it.
Yeah, absolutely.
We've done it at night. You know, we've done it starting at 8 o'clock and fucking got faded. You start at noon or 10 a.m. and you go too hard. But I remember during the drive, we got a cooler. I'm drinking Bud Light. And I remember I don't know if I said anything or not, but I remember thinking, this isn't smart. I can tell by your speech, you're just faded, bro. You're not gonna make it. Yeah. I remember thinking like, this is 2 a.m. That's a long time. You're not gonna make it. Because
you
can't.
You can start at that time and make it there, but not like that. So yeah, you already seeing it. Probably an hour, maybe an hour into the trip.
I wasn't mixing anything. I wasn't mixing anything. I had worked 6 to 2 that day. Right? I didn't eat breakfast. Yeah. Right? And I'm pretty sure I ate like a small lunch, surprisingly. And so like I had barely eaten anything that day.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then I'm on the road drinking in a car. And then if you ever driven from Lincoln to Manhattan, it's windy.
Oh, yeah.
You know, like.
Yeah. We got stuck.
We got stuck in the mud.
Yeah.
Like, I wasn't ready, dude. I wasn't ready. I thought I was ready.
Yeah.
Buddy Holly wasn't ready.
Buddy Holly was. You were more ready than Buddy Holly.
Yeah, I was, though. Buddy Holly, if you're listening, dude, fuck you.
I totally forgot about that. Like, when he said to the black friend, it came back to me. I was like, I haven't heard that story in years.
Yeah, that was great.
Oh, my God.
I did that before. It brought me a story. I'm not going to tell the whole story, but. My sister got married. Her ex-husband's bachelor party. I was fucked, and I showed up fucked. I can't remember exactly what happened. I think I was working nights or was working security. I got off that morning. I watched a Husker game. I started drinking vodka. Yeah. Started drinking more vodka. We met up downtown, and I'm already fucked. There's all these. It was Nebraska lost to Texas. I don't remember what year it was, but they played in the snow. Nebraska would have won.
It was a close game.
If somebody didn't fumble. I can't remember who the running back was. This is maybe 05. The running back fumbled. I don't know if
it was the first snow of the year, wasn't it?
I don't remember,
I think it was the first snow of the year.
I remember that. They had the game won. Mm-hmm. All they had to do was hold on to the ball. Running back fumbled. He would have had the first down fumbled. Texas kicked the field goal.
Right.
So it was all these, it was at home. All these Texas fans were downtown. Yeah. Like old Chicago drinking and shit.
This is like 07, actually. I remember that. Okay. Yeah.
I'm buying my sister's fiance shots of like fucking Shirley Temple shit with whipped cream on it, but I'm fucked up. Like, he's a cop. He had a bunch of cop friends. Everybody's pretty normal. I'm like falling. I'm fucked. I'm like fucked up. I convinced him to go to the strip club. Shit goes wrong. We end up meeting with the girls, having their party. I remember my sister like crying and like, what the fuck is, I don't remember. And then, yeah, I was fucked. Like I was fucked up. It was embarrassing. It's a great story. I can't tell the whole story, but I could not recover from that. I was fucked up. I gave zero fucks.
Dude, we've all been there. It happens. Oh, yeah. It happens to the best of us.
I think I'm in a strip club, like texting and shit. They're like, sir, how many times we got to tell you? I'm like, I ain't, yeah, whatever.
Spicy,
yeah.
We know you're here every week, but Jesus.
Yeah. It's happened to everybody, but not everybody can recover by dropping Buddy Holly lines and fucking, that was impressive, dude. I'll never forget that, man.
Yeah, dude, that's
all my grandkids about that shit. That's fucking awesome.
So, it's some good shit. Dude, you got some good, like what we talked about in at 7.5, how like we usually when we get together, we try and drop the biggest heat. A lot of people, like it drilled, dude. That's all we try to do is just try to fucking top one each other.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You know,
we got some good ones, man.
Oh, my God, dude. This is a lot of talent. It's tough.
It's tough, dude.
I swear to God, man. Everybody's good.
Yeah. Now, we had some good times. Just stupid shit.
Yeah, no.
Just,
and for real, like, you two motherfuckers are some of the funniest motherfuckers I know. Like, you guys always bring heat.
Oh,
I brought this up. I brought this up in a. It might have been the last podcast, but people send you text messages or memes or videos or whatever. Hey, check this out. And then for me, you know, I get them. You know, like, I'm in so many different group texts.
Yeah.
This morning I woke up, 40 text messages. I thought somebody died. Damn, I'm like, dude. Oh, okay. It's just different group text messages.
One of the groups was us.
Yeah, one of the groups was us.
Are you the story?
I'm pretty sure I text y'all like 6:30 in the morning. What time we doing the damn thing?
It was
close. I you know, so anyway, but you're another one. I told Pags this. If you know, some people send me shit, I'm like, oh, okay. All right, whatever. And then some of that shit is annoying. Like Long.
Oh, yeah.
Long will send shit. And how YouTube works is, they recommend shit. So I got so much I clear my history on YouTube because they'll recommend shit. I watch one video and now they got like all this. So anyway, if Pag sends me some shit, I know it's going to be funny. I know it's solid. You're the same way, dude.
Yeah.
You, both of you guys are two of the funniest motherfuckers I know, man.
I just don't send mediocre shit.
No, absolutely not.
I, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I'm not trying to waste anybody's time.
No.
Seriously.
No.
So, you know.
Yeah.
I know what you're saying. Like,
yeah.
You get so much, I call it spam. So much spam during the day from people. It's dude, you wasted my fucking time over this? Like,
yeah, man.
You wasted my time over some freaking, although, man, I won't, all right, I'll say it.
All right, do it.
Somebody sent me a meme today of the Donald Trump Tower, and on top of it, it said, go ahead, Bush, go and get you some.
Jesus.
That's
fucking
It was
great.
Something like, it was like,
that's really
it
good.
Was like, go ahead, Bush, go on, do your thing. It was something like that, dude. I was dying.
That's really good.
That's awesome. One. Those, you just don't. Those are the ones like you save and you just held it. You hold it. You just don't start sending it right. There's something you just hold from.
Yeah, because you do that shit all the time. Like, we'll start like in a group message. We'll just send like a meme or whatever, and then you'll just fucking come back with that. You're like, you know, he's been waiting. He's sitting on that bush because he ain't gonna be outdone. Sure.
Lately, I've been like. And this sounds weird. Lately, I've been really big in these funny dog faces. You saw my Facebook profile picture of that dog.
Yeah.
These funny dog. Whoever's getting these dogs high, like y'all.
Congratulations.
Respect. Put some respect on it.
Yeah.
Like seriously, man, that shit is hilarious. That shit is so funny.
Yeah, dude.
It's good shit.
Speaking of like internet shit or whatever. So like I don't got cable. So last night I was just fucking hanging out. I think. Me and Shorty, we've been watching, she's never watched Breaking Bad, so we've been watching that. One or two episodes a night, every now and then we'll binge. We're in the final season, shit's fucking intense.
Yeah.
I was checking the draft on my phone every now and then.
Yeah.
And then I worked today part-time at the arena. and
the NFL draft for people. Yeah, the NFL whenever draft. You listen to it, I don't know when you'll get to it. So it's the NFL.
NFL he's draft. Talking about the racial draft.
They just passed it.
They just passed it, dude. Lenny Kravitz went to the Jews. Only half of them, though.
Tiger Woods wants the Whites. So they're like, you watch the draft? And I said, no. I said, I don't got cable. I was kind of, you know, checking updates on my phone.
Yeah.
And they're like, did you hear what happened? I said, no. They said, one of the craziest shit that ever happened during the draft happened last night. I said, what? What is this? So they started telling me about it. I'm like, no shit. So we're watching ESPN in the first aid room. And this is the story that I've gathered so far. Laramie Tunsil. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right.
Tunsil, yeah.
Tunsil. A lot of people had him projected to go real early in the draft.
Yeah.
And he had some altercations. He played for Ole Miss. He had some altercations with like his stepfather or some other shit. He had some problems going into it. Allegations of money.
Yeah, he admitted that the coach had given him money throughout the season for whatever reason.
All right. So I think illegal. That was after. I think
yeah,
that
was after. Yeah, okay, but it's illegal in NCAA sports.
Okay. So what happened is some people projected him to go early. I think they said 13 minutes before the draft started.
Yeah, it was.
He was sitting in the audience. And somebody hacked his Twitter. Was it Twitter or Instagram?
It was Twitter.
Twitter. His Twitter account, and they posted a picture of him.
It was a video.
A video. I'm sorry. A video of him smoking a bong with a gas mask on. So I'm like, well, did they show his face?
Yeah, because he takes it off.
A long ass face, yeah, and then lifts it up, and it's him.
It's him, dude.
So like 13 minutes before, which is straight hater shit. Like that's fucked up.
You know they've been sitting on that.
Well, hey, not only that, you're fucking with people's money now.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? Like that dude's about to get paid.
Yeah. So that video came out 13 minutes before the draft, and then another time in the draft, they post screenshots of text messages of him and one of the coaches for Ole Miss. Talking about money, paying his mom's rent, need more money. So he falls to 13, gets drafted by Miami. And so I'm like, what the fuck? So we're watching this at work. And they're supposed to have a press conference. And on the press conference, it says Laramie Tunsil can't come to the press conference because he's having an allergic reaction. And I'm like, well, Jesus Christ. That's like a horrible excuse. Like, this guy, just give him Benadryl.
Yeah, dude. Just say that, like, his fucking team wants to talk to him.
Right. Yeah.
Say
like
something
else.
His agent.
Yeah.
Right.
But okay. So my thing on it. He's a college kid.
Right.
Smoking marijuana. Who gives a shit? I don't know why the NFL tests for marijuana because it's not a PED.
Right.
A performance enhancing drug.
It actually is the complete opposite.
It's stupid. And either way, yeah, it's illegal in the NFL, but he's a fucking college kid.
Right.
That's what college kids do. It's better than drinking.
Like, didn't he?
It's better than showing him chugging vodka.
No, agree. But if he did, that would be okay.
Yeah.
But if, didn't he say he was like in high school? So it may not have even been like it was within the last year.
Yeah, or
I mean, it was,
or he was in Colorado or like, Washington, like, California.
I see both ends of it. I see it as you're a professional.
Right.
You know, the Miami Dolphins don't want that sort of image. You know, and like what, you know, and I get it, like whatever. But, at the, you know, in the aspect too is as much as athletes may not want to accept it, they're kind of role models to kids. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
And so like, say this kid has a big rookie season and his jersey starts selling and there's kids that look up to him in the city of Miami. And the kids are like, oh, I want to buy Tinsel's, whatever his name is. I want to buy Joe Schmo's jersey.
Yeah.
Parents are going to be like, no.
Yeah.
You know, and so like that's gonna take away from Miami Dolphins. At the end of the day, it's about money.
Right.
Boy,
you know, it falls
about
back
money.
About money.
No,
you know?
I agree with you.
You know,
he didn't post the video.
Right.
Somebody else hacked
somebody,
his account,
right,
post the video.
Right.
And if he was chugging vodka or if he was chugging a beer, it wouldn't be that big,
wouldn't be that
deal,
big a deal
because everybody's like, oh,
right,
you could drink beer everywhere.
Right.
You could get drunk and throw up, that's okay. It's still not a good role model, but they would be like, oh well.
Right. I mean,
it's just
in today's day and age, man, pot's not even really a drug. I mean, I don't smoke pot. That's not my thing, you know, but I don't see it as a problem.
Right.
No,
but
whatever,
my thing is he did it so long ago.
Right.
You know, it'd be different if he, like, fuck it. It was the video that he walked out to the draft.
Yeah. To that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like,
I hear
they're making a big. They're making a big deal out of it. I don't think it's a big deal. The other part, the money, I don't know where this kid comes from. He's 21 years old. He's from Mississippi. Mississippi is a real quick, fuck Mississippi. They're racist. They don't like gays. They just passed that law or whatever.
I can't spell the name.
They're like the worst in the nation of schools. My daughter went to school in Mississippi because my ex-wife is an Air Force, and they had to go to a private school, and even that I don't think was great. But yeah, fuck Mississippi. But I don't know where this kid. He's probably poor. He was asking money to pay his mom's rent or whatever. Like it's the school's fault, Ole Miss's fault, yeah, for giving him money or offering that. I don't think it's bad for that. The biggest thing I saw was today watching replays of last night. They did a short press conference.
Yeah.
Before it got stopped, they were asking him about the shit, and he's like, "Yeah, I guess. I mean, that was me." He's honest. And then a lady comes up and is like, he's not taking any more questions or whatever. And to me, I'm like, that's fucking good. You know, I mean, to be honest, nobody does that. Any fucking politician, whether it's the senator or somebody running for president, they don't admit answer to it. Any questions. They'll avoid the question or lie or bullshit. Any business person is going to be like, well, I'd have to. You know, I don't.
He's
just a kid. And he's like, yeah, that was me. I did it.
He's a young kid. There's got to be like statute of limitations to that shit.
Yeah.
You know, if a freaking cop knocked on the door right now and said some dude named Buddy Holly was pressing charges on me because I pushed him in the bathroom in Manhattan, Kansas, I'd be like, you know what? Mm-hmm. You fucking deserved it. He was breathing down my neck when I was taking a pee. You know?
I mean, when I was pee-peeing.
But no, anybody in... It's all about money.
It's all about money. Everybody's
gonna. That's why they're like, don't do the press conference. You had an allergic reaction. We're gonna talk. We're gonna tell you what to say. Whatever. For somebody to be honest to me is big.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Whether it's gonna get other people in trouble. He can't get in trouble for accepting money anymore. He didn't win Heisman. They can't take his Heisman like they did Reggie Bush. But you know, other people can get implicated. You know, and whatever. But the fact that he's like, you know, that was me. I don't know what to say. I got hacked.
Right.
It's good. Because any fucking politician, they're fucking snakes. They're going to bullshit, lie, whatever.
Yeah.
So I respect that.
And no, 100%.
I don't think it's pretty crazy. It's entertaining. It's all over the news if you watch ESPN or any of that shit. But like for me, like just watching it today, it's a fucking circus. And I feel bad for the kid.
Right.
He's got problems with family, like suing him and shit. And now like somebody hacked him during the NFL draft where he might have went number one. He fell to 13. He's still going to make money. But yeah, there's going to be memes about him. There's going to be shit about him. There's all the
he's going to get the Jordan crying meme.
Yeah.
He's not my favorite right now, by the way.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Maybe you could explain where. I don't know where it came from.
He had a press conference
okay.
a while back. And during the press conference, he just started busting out crying. I think the press conference was about
pussy.
The press conference was something about his shoes or something like that. Like a deal he made. And he was and he just started talking about like his retirement and just everything.
Okay.
And he just started crying. So people naturally just took that picture and they started just shitting all over the internet. I think it's great.
Yeah, no, thanks. I didn't know where it came from.
Yeah, but it's press everywhere. From a press conference.
It's everywhere and it's so good.
Right. It's great.
So
it's
good.
Awesome, dude.
During March Madness, it was everywhere.
The whole bracket was all awesome.
Yeah.
It's a fucking great meme. It's one of my favorite ones. And like you, I think you're right. It's probably my favorite. But to get back to what's his face?
Tonsil?
Yeah. I mean, like you said, you're fucking with people's money. He could have gone earlier.
That's
the
whole up.
The worst part about the entire thing was he got drafted by the Dolphins. Like, let's not skip over that, you know, right now at all. So,
what, living in Miami? Making millions of dollars?
Partying with Sue.
Yeah, partying with Sue.
With a boy named Sue.
Yeah.
Shouts out Sue. Shouts out Tonsil. Like, he's a 21-year-old. He's going to make bad decisions. He shouldn't have had a video of him smoking out of a gas mask bong, but he's a college kid and he's smoking weed. Somebody else hacked his account and that motherfucker, fuck them. That's shitty.
Yeah, that's shitty, man.
I never heard of the dude. I honestly never heard of the dude until today. And he had a fucking bad day yesterday. It should have get better for him. But it's a current event, so I figured we'd bring it up because people are talking about it. But
yeah.
If you got thoughts about it, or you're really like, you guys are fucking stupid.
Yeah. Keep it to yourself. This your is
the deal. Don't email us that shit. Keep that shit to yourself.
Yeah, you sons of bitches. We need more emails, by the way.
You haters.
Which, by the way, you were the one of the first ones to send us an email.
What's an email?
you just sent it to nastyandfriends@gmail.com.
I did.
You just said, I don't remember the fucking subject line was, enjoy these pictures. Like,
oh, yeah.
It might have said scumbags, actually, now that I think of it.
Yeah. I dropped some heat notes.
There's some good memes, some good old school pictures from some of the Army guys. Oh, some
We appreciate that shit, man. We appreciate that. It's all love.
It's all love, baby. It's all love.
So, speaking of good pictures, I know you don't know because I haven't told you. Okay. I think I've only maybe told one other person. But I was fucking sitting at work the other day. And when I say the other day, it was like a couple months ago. I'm fucking sitting there. It's like probably 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Right. Maybe.
Okay.
And I'm fucking sitting there on my phone. It fucking comes up and it says Snapchat. I'm like, it's from Melina. I was like, oh, sweet. 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Right. I'm like, it's probably something funny.
Yeah.
I fucking click on it and I just go, Jesus. It was fucking a 2-second Snapchat of fucking somebody going down on him. It's like a picture out here. I'm like, I like literally sent one back. I go, it's 2 in the afternoon. And it was like 45 minutes later, a couple hours later or something. He fucking sat back and goes, whoops. And his eyes are just fucking, you know, just like that. My bad.
It's a long blowjob.
Had to make him sound good. It was really no. But it was just funny. I was like, oh, like, was fucking sitting working, middle of the afternoon. I'm like, oh my
Curtis God. Carlin style.
Exactly.
Curtis Carlin style.
Roll down on Snapchat.
Curtis
Shouts
Carlin
out
style.
Carlin.
Yeah, shout out Carlin, dude. Me and Carlin just went to Chicago for the second time.
Yeah, I saw that. Yeah. Ingram and Kringleberry was there.
I
and
don't
who else?
Fucking worry about it.
That's some
tough shit. Yeah, Engelman and Tenfon. And not.
Oh, yeah,
Engelman,
yeah, yeah.
Not and Carlin.
All right.
And, it was cool. It was a cool little trip.
Nice. Chicago, I love that city, man.
Yeah.
It's one of my favorite cities. Good food city.
It is.
Good people.
It's a great city. It's
they love veterans there. Yeah. A lot of discounts for Navy Pier, all those places. Right. They hear your military, fuck, they take care of you. Not a lot of cities are like
that. That's where all the Navy people go for boot camp.
Yeah. Navy?
Yeah, those fucks.
Like
I said military. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, we're talking military, not Navy.
No, yeah, no, it's awesome. You get free bus rides. You don't have to pay for bus rides.
Yeah, they take care of you. Great city. I love Chicago. Sorry, man. Go ahead.
Nah, that's cool.
That was it.
Tell the story.
I'm just saying, shout out to Carlin, Engelman, and Knott. We had a fun little trip.
Anything get weird.
Engelman, you need to. This dude shows up, no credit card, no ID. I'm here to get a hotel room. I'm like, but you don't have a credit card or a hotel.
Well, I left it at home.
I'm like, dude. I'm going to be your dad this trip.
It was bad.
Yeah,
I hope you like watching me have sex, motherfucker. It's going to be weird if it's staying with me.
Yeah. Freaking Engelman, man.
Oh, Jesus.
He's a good kid.
He is a good kid. He's the young kid. Yeah. You know, he was a 245. Respect.
I love seeing that shit. Like, people fuck up like that. Oh, because we all been there and done it. So, like, especially when you see it.
No. He goes to the front. No, this is what he does. He goes to the front of the desk and he goes, I was just wondering if I can check into the hotel and just give you the credit card number, not the actual credit card. And I'm like, oh my God.
Have you not been out of town before?
Like, and he turns around and he goes, what? I'm like, nothing, man. Nothing, dude. Hey, finish checking in.
I'd like to give you this IOU.
Yeah, dude, then
just send me a bill. Like,
yep.
It's 15,000. Might want to keep that one.
Oh, that's fucking crazy.
Oh, that's great.
So Engelman's our dude.
Yeah.
I got stories about Engelman. New York City, he did some fucked up shit there too. Yeah. I don't know. Keep going.
Yeah, so anyways. man. Good guy. Just had to be his dad.
He's a young guy, man. We've all made mistakes.
Yeah.
I've given him advice. I don't think he'd listen to it.
Yeah.
As a young gentleman.
As a young gentleman, they don't take advice well, you know. So I've given him plenty of advice, and he'll learn. He'll learn the hard way.
Yeah.
So, good shit.
Yeah, he's a good dude. Real
Anyways,
good dude.
We were there. We bought superhero t-shirts. And we saw that picture put on Facebook. Yeah.
Smart.
That was Batman.
Yeah.
Yeah. Engelman was the Flash.
Okay.
Carlin was Captain America, and Knott was the Hulk.
Okay.
So, on that subject, Batman and Superman, Loved it. I loved it.
Yeah, oh, I loved it too.
I thought it was great. I saw it twice just because I felt like I missed a lot of stuff the first time around.
Right.
I know people didn't like it because they thought it dragged on in the beginning. And I feel like if you watch it the second time, the movie will make a little bit more sense to you. Like, you'll have a little bit more understanding that you have to understand, like, this movie is setting up an Aquaman movie.
Okay.
A Justice League movie.
Okay.
A Wonder Woman movie. A standalone Batman movie. Now they said they're coming up. A little bit of Suicide Squad. It's setting up a lot. So
it's good.
It has to drag on a little bit. You know what I'm saying? To give the origins and stuff. And you know, like, I hate how people just criticize movies all the time. Like, I just wish people would. There's people on Facebook that just don't like it. You notice they just hate every movie. Hate it. It's like, dude, I know your life ain't good.
No.
I know your fucking life is miserable. Get out of your miserable life, clear your head, enjoy this 2-hour fucking movie, and that's it. Like, people worked hard to put together these movies.
Yeah.
Like, just, this ain't real. It's a movie, dog. Like, you know?
Yeah, and I think people, like, read a book or read a comic book, and they expect something, and when they get something else delivered, they're like, that's not what I had
but
in
the
mind.
But the author... Right. The author's different than from the director. Yeah, there's two different visions, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And it's like, but I was talking to my roommate about it the other day, and he was talking about the reason he thinks people didn't like it. He brought up a good point. He said, you know, when you go to, like, somewhere of entertainment, if you go to, like WWE or anything where, like, you're there for entertainment, they build it up for you.
Yeah.
They keep you on the edge of your seat to build up something next.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They just don't end it, have a, like, an ending, and then you know the ending. Like, they try to build it up. And he said the reason he thinks people didn't like it is because they kill – for the people who didn't see it.
I didn't see it.
Oh, okay. Well,
No, finish.
The reason people
around.
Probably don't like it is because Superman dies at the end.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
You know, and so, and that makes sense. Like, people don't want to
see. Spoiler alert.
People don't want to see Superman dying at the end. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, because then it's like, it's over. There's nothing else to see anymore. You know what I'm saying? So, like, you got to keep, you know, things at the, you got to keep people at the edge of their seat, you know? You got to keep them wanting more and wanting more. I liked it. And, I was talking to Pag Nasty about it before. I like the Jason Todd theory going in the Suicide Squad.
Yeah.
Well, if you look during the Batman Superman movie, when Ben Affleck, Batfleck, is that what it's called?
Yeah, Batfleck.
Batfleck. When he walks by the Batman suit.
Yeah.
He walks by the other one. People thought it was a Batman suit, but it was the Robin suit.
Yeah.
And the Robin suit says, ha, 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 joke's on you, Batman.
Yeah.
Well, if you notice, it has the R, and it's got the two gunshot wounds. Well, if you see Jared Leto's Suicide Squad Joker picture, he's got bullet marks in the same
spot. They're like scars. It's not official that it's
not official.
But that's
it's a possibility.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
And then on his arm, he's got like a wing, like a bird wing.
Okay.
You know, so it could be like he was Robin. And in the Suicide Squad comic, there's a story of Jason Todd as Robin turning bad and turning into the Joker. All
right.
So, and then Ben Affleck's obviously going to be Suicide Squad.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, is going to be like the best movie of the fucking
year.
Dude,
I'm excited about that.
That or Civil War.
Civil War looks great. Looks great.
I think it'll be Suicide Squad. That's what
right.
I'm
a DC guy, but I'll give Marvel a chance for sure. But
like Spencer, he's a big comic book guy. He didn't like the movie. And he sent me this big email on why, and he does make some great points. I don't remember exactly what it is. I'm not a big movie critic. His point of view, and I don't really think he's a big movie critic either. He's more of like for shows and stuff. But he has the theory, but he just feels like they could do so much more with the Batman versus Superman. He goes, I understand it's a setup for the Justice League movie and shit, but
it's a big rivalry.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You can do like 3 or 4 movies with them. You know?
Exactly. Yeah. And he just felt like, again, if I remember right, you can't copy Marvel, but Marvel did it right where they had their origin stories and they came together. And I think DC, because their movies have been pretty shitty for the most part, they're just trying to catch up.
Yeah.
And he had some other points. He would some points that they didn't go into that he would love to see. And I think I still, like I said, have the whole email. I'll let you read it. He makes some good points. And he said next time, he goes, I don't care if I'm not on until like another 3 years. I want to talk about that movie and give my opinion. So, but it's good to hear both sides. For me, I fucking loved every bit of it.
Yeah.
It wasn't boring for me. But again, I always go to movies like I'm not.
And people hated when they first announced that Ben Affleck was me back. People hated it.
I know.
But I thought he did great. And
I think he was one of the best parts of the movie.
Yeah, I think he did great. And the reason I think he did great is because he didn't try to do too much.
Right.
If you think about it, he didn't have a lot of dialogue. You know?
Yeah.
He had a lot of moments in the movie where he wasn't really talking and he was just acting, you know?
Yeah, he's
and
good.
I think that's that really shows the this dark side version of the Batman, which was great. And I think he did awesome. He wasn't trying too hard with his dialogue. And,
right.
You know, and I think that played in perfect with the actor he is, you know, because we're so used to him playing other roles and stuff, you know, and I thought it worked out great.
Yeah, I thought it was great. And I think I've been looking forward to Suicide Squad more than Batman versus Superman, just because it's like, I know Batman's going to be in it. He won't be in it a lot.
Right.
But I knew this was going to be kind of a setup movie for, you know, Batman versus Superman as well. So I can't fuck away. August 5th it comes out.
What do you think about the Jared Leto Joker?
I think he's going to be fucking awesome.
Yeah.
I think it's
fucking fantastic. Have you heard what he's been doing?
He's been spending time, like, with fucking, actual crazy people.
Right. But did you see what he was doing on set?
Oh, no.
Okay, so what he's been doing on set is, you know, in the movie he's got, like, his henchmen, like, with Johnny Frost.
Right.
He was sending, when they would have, like, because he never got out of character, like Ledger.
Right.
Well, I've been reading that when they'd have, like, meetings about, you know, what they were doing that day on set, he'd have one of his henchmen go into, like, the meeting room where they'd, like, have this big tabletop, you know, tabletop of, like, reading material, and they drop a dead fucking pig on the table and just walk out.
And then
Clint Eastwood's son was saying, I've never met Jared Leto. I've only met the Joker, and I'm fucking terrified.
Jesus.
Will Smith said the same thing. He sent used condoms to Margaret Robbie and to Will Smith, and he was sending anal beads to him.
Jesus.
Yep. I mean, just these weird, crazy things.
He's fucking great.
And have you seen Jared Leto acting in other movies? Like,
Dallas Buyers Club?
Yeah, in Chapter 27, where he plays Mark David Chapman, the assassination of John Lennon.
Yeah.
He gained like 50 pounds with that role.
Yeah.
And it was creepy as shit. And so, like, if there was somebody to play the Joker, like, I think William Dafoe could play a great Joker just because of the way he looks. But it's kind of fucked
up.
I think that's actually
a woman. William Dafoe, I'm sure.
You know, Caitlyn Jenner would be a great Joker. But Jared Leto's perfect. And I like his look.
Oh, I love it.
And people are just such fucking critics. Like, when the Star Wars trailers came out, everyone was bitching about Kylo Ren's lightsaber and shit like that. Now everyone fucking loves it.
Right.
Like, give it a shot. Before you have these...
Motherfuckers can't wait to hate, man.
Yeah, dude.
They want to blog or podcast.
They want I'm out of here.
or talk shit, you know? Yeah.
Like, appreciate someone else's work.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Put some respect on their fucking name.
Yeah. Just because it's not what you imagine doesn't mean it's not good.
Right.
But yeah.
That's somebody else's vision. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Let's see you do better.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
You know
what I'm saying?
Let's see you fucking push somebody to call him Buddy Holly. Yeah. You know, that's my vision, dude.
Yeah, man. So you do that, you don't even fuck with us.
Right.
We ain't fucking with you, you know? No, that's good, dude. Like, I enjoy hearing you talk about it. You haven't listened to the last podcast. But we go in depth on...
Wait. This isn't the first episode?
Nope.
Nah, man. We had a few before this.
All right.
But
I'll let it slide.
In the last one, we go in depth. And I really enjoyed Pags talking about Superman versus Batman. So hearing you talk about it is good. I didn't know you were going to drop a spoiler. You dropped some heat. So for people who aren't ready for that,
yeah.
Hey... Fuck it. Now you know. You should have watched it. You had a couple weeks, you know. But no, I enjoy you talking about it too, and I am excited about watching the movie. I just haven't got around to watching it, and I enjoy looking forward to Suicide Squad and all that shit. So that's cool.
What I'm gonna do, I almost did it for the Star Wars movie.
Mm-hmm.
I'm about to buy out the whole theater. I had the opportunity to buy out a whole show.
Take notes.
Seriously, I had the opportunity to do it.
Yeah,
I was the first one in line.
Yeah.
I was the first one in line. And the guy was like, what's available? Like, everything's available. I'm like, so I can buy the whole theater? He's like, yeah, if you want to. And I was like, I don't feel like being a dickhead today. So I only bought the back row. But I'm going to do the same for Suicide Squad.
Right.
I'm actually going to buy the whole theater. I'm going to have all my homies come out.
Yeah.
And we're going to, everyone's invited. Except for,
Engelman?
Yeah, there you go. Because he ain't going to bring his ID.
No.
And it's R rated.
Can you vouch for him?
Yeah.
Nah.
No, everyone's invited. All my homies are invited. I'll buy out like 30 seats.
Okay.
And we'll go to that bar, that bistro, whatever. Have some drinks before the movie.
Yeah,
watch the movie.
It'll be fun.
It'll be fun. It'll be a good time.
Yeah, it'll be a great time. That'll be good.
It'll be really good.
So, and yeah, dude, I talking about Affleck.
Yeah.
Affleck. Said he did good. Dude, I'm a fan, man. We talked about this in the last podcast, but yeah, everybody's like, fucking Ben Affleck. I'm like, yeah, why not? He's a fucking great actor. He's good. That fucking chin. I'm excited to see the movie, man. I'm glad you said
he looks
good.
Like Pag Nasty.
Yeah.
He does, dude.
A little. He's got a better chin.
He got.
Oh, come on, man. Oh. Come on.
Thanks, guys.
Come on.
I tell you what he doesn't have.
What's that?
A lifetime supply of fucking ragu.
Very true. You know I'm fucking stoked. Yep. Go home. JPEGs.
We made it. JPEGs, we made it, baby.
We'd make it there one day. I told you. Yeah. You didn't believe me. Your mother thought I was a hack. Gotta love it. Gotta love it.
Yeah.
Real quick, shouts out JPEGs.
Yeah, man. You struck gold, man. Seriously.
Yeah.
Your wife's awesome.
Yeah, dude.
She
puts up with me, so she's okay by my book.
Yeah.
No, she's awesome. She's been working her ass off. Like I said, we put a bid on this house, and we're doing all our inspections on Monday. So
cool, I'm moving in.
Yeah, but she's she's been working her ass off on it, doing all the stuff, like dealing with the agent and shit like that. Cool. So. Hopefully we'll be having a housewarming party.
Yeah. Dude, I don't know if I ever told you this, but I told you I was in Chicago with Chop.
Yeah.
Years ago, me and our buddy Chopper, who's a big fan of the show, much respect. We went to Chicago for a week and we did an army class. And there's a lot of stories that came out of that.
Oh, my God.
Because Chop's a unique guy, to say the least.
Tip of the sword, man.
Yeah. Unique character, to say the least. So I got some stories out of that. I enjoy telling those. I'll tell them another time. But during that time, I can't remember exactly. This was years ago. But I remember you called me. You didn't text me. And you said, hey, I'm going on vacation with JPEGs. To
Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico. And you were like,
to homeland. Your homeland.
Homeland, baby. And you were like,
it was fucking horrible. No, I'm just
kidding. You're like, I'm gonna propose. Propose JPEGs. And people have told me that same thing, and I've been like, no.
Yeah.
Honestly.
Not being funny.
Really. Yeah, not even be funny. One of our good buddies. Diamond. I say his name Diamond.
Yeah, if I say it, I don't give a fuck, dude.
He it's a whole other. That's a whole other story I could get into. Yeah. But
Married a young bird.
I said no. I said don't. No, dude, I said don't do it. People tell me that, and it's sad that it's like that, but the way life is.
But that's what a homie does, man. Seriously,
yeah, if you know both people, usually I'm like, that's nice. Well, I don't
and
understand.
And if they're really your homie, you'd listen up.
You're honest.
Well, you'd listen up to them. Well, the reasons why.
Yeah, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Some people don't. They're like, no, I don't know what I'm doing. Well, but both of our families don't want it to happen either. I'm like, it's a sign. Maybe you should start listening to people. Honestly, most people, I hear about people getting married or people tell me, and I'm just like, fucking schmucks. Don't do it.
Another one.
Especially when things are bad, it's like, that's not going to help.
No, I'm pretty sure everybody that... All our buddy, mm-hmm. all the crew. When we knew Pac Nasty was gonna get married, JPEG, we were all wrong. We were stoked. We were so excited.
No, dude, I'm like, oh my god, like that's great because I love both you guys, man. You guys are family. And then, so I think it was the end of the, it was the end of the week. I want to say it was the end of the week because I remember me and Chop went to. We were taking I think it was instructor 2 course,
mm-hmm.
and they're like, you don't have class today, go back to your hotel, study, and then come back and take the test. And that was the day of one of the great stories where we went to a local fire department and we had the fiasco. You guys know the story. I'm not going to tell it. It was that day.
Are you a trap?
But that day, I think he called me back and was like, it went down. She said yes. And honestly, dude,
mm-hmm.
I teared up a little
bit. Oh, yeah. Well, thanks, man. That's awesome, dude. That's
that
awesome.
That doesn't happen, dog.
Right.
Not that I don't tear up, but right. for yeah. something like that, usually yeah. I'd be like,
for sure.
Yeah, whatever. Absolutely. Like, yeah, whatever. Of yeah. course she's going to say yeah. yeah. But yeah, no, dude, like that. I was really excited.
Yeah, oh, dude, that's awesome. I appreciate it. You probably also teared up because you knew it was going to be another unit wedding.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. No, you knew, yeah, you knew it got a little crazy because I didn't see it, but from what I heard, the Army guys on the dance floor at our reception did the human centipede. Oh, so, yeah. So, but yeah, no, it was all that. Dude, that's fucking awesome.
Yeah. yeah. No, I don't know if I ever told you that. I didn't want to tell you that. I did. Honestly, yeah, and that's honest. Sure. That's honest as fuck. Absolutely. But yeah, no, unit weddings. Can't wait for another person. Can't wait to get wedding. That's Harris.
Yeah,
our boy
yeah,
Harris
is coming up. The end of
we're in the wedding.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that son of a bitch.
Yeah, it's coming up. His bachelor party's coming up. So yeah, yeah. It'd be a good time. But yeah, that's the next unit wedding. So yeah. It should be a fucking shit show. I cannot wait.
Bachelor party's in 2 weeks. Wedding's in like a month. Should I be honest? Yeah.
Fucking of course. You're in a safe place. Yeah. It's okay. Nobody's going to hear it. Like, yeah. We won't tell anybody.
All right. So my whole thing is weddings suck. Okay?
Yeah.
So you find out you're in a wedding and you're like, okay. So we went through the whole group text thing. You got to get a tux. You got to get measured. I'm like, well, is there one in local? No. I'm like, I'm just going to have my girl fucking measuring. He's like, you can't. You're wearing group text. It's like, you can't do that. I say, yeah, bullshit. I got Google. I'll fucking know how to measure my shit. So I have her measure me and give them the measurements.
It's just kind of weird because usually when you're like, hey, I'm
but
getting...
you can go anywhere to get measured.
Yeah, I don't have time, man.
Yeah, but it was like one of those things.
I'm a busy motherfucker.
Dog. Yeah, I mean, you could go, let's go here right. to get it. But it was just like, hey, I need these measurements. Like, well, where'd you get it at? Like, we could right. I could just go. Mm-hmm. And so he's like, I don't have time. He's mm-hmm. like, I'll just have, you know, my girl measure mm-hmm. me.
Right.
So I did it. Harris, I know you're listening. Hopefully, if not, eh, fuck you. Listen, it's all good.
So you got measured.
Yeah, so she measured me. And we're going back and forth in the right. group text. And I don't know everybody in the group text, but I'm just being me. And I'm like, no, I got fucking Google. I'm going to get... I don't have time to go to a fucking
right.
thing. I'll be fine. You say, you're going to look like shit. Like, I don't give a fuck. This is not my wedding. So she does measure me, and I send them the thing. But other people in the group text are sending pictures to them with, like, yardsticks.
His brother, because he works construction, it was yeah. a fucking
tape measure.
The tape measured, like, down to his legs. Like, yeah, this looks like it's it.
So now we're trolling Harris. And he does hey, not like
he's stressing. Yeah, yeah, yeah. He's stressing, dude.
Like, I don't give a fuck.
He's about to throw his phone up the fucking window.
Yeah,
yeah.
Yeah, and Harris and Timmery, I'm happy for them. Yeah. I'm not hating.
But again, I've been there. I mean, you've been there. Like, yeah. It's a stressful yeah. time for it's him. Stressful. So he's probably just like, I can't.
Hey, but that's another couple they're meant to be.
Yeah. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
Absolutely.
You know but saying? Like I said, yeah, we're trying to fucking have fun, and I know he's just like, God damn it.
Oh, he's probably like
I'm sure like Timmery's like, we need to get this shit done. So, but yeah, it was fucking funny. Like, as soon as you hit it, dude, everybody started
going. And I don't even know other people. I'm like, I don't know who's in the text. I give a fuck. This is how I feel. So then I'm like, well, fuck. Like when it's your wedding,
yeah,
you're like, this is a big deal. When you're not in it, you're like, fuck.
You should have sent a picture of a ruler
yeah.
with the 9-inch mark cast. I think, go guess what this is for.
Yeah. Hey, it's spicy. You gotta take two rollers together, make it long.
So yeah. Anyway, so now you're in a wedding and I'm an usher. So now I do worry about like how I'm gonna come off to people,
right?
Because I'm an outgoing person, but I'm not always friendly all the time. And you know how I am, like
right.
I'm gonna treat it like I'm working security. So I'm already like I gotta buy a tux.
Threat level midnight.
I gotta buy fucking chucks. I gotta buy shoelaces. I gotta get a hotel room. I gotta get a gift. And now I'm working the wedding. So like I'm not expecting any fuckery at this thing.
Yeah.
Like I've never been an usher at a wedding, but like I expect if I'm not gonna fucking fuck around with anybody. So if anybody gives me any flack, I'm gonna be like, I don't know what the fuck your problem is.
Yeah.
You can either sit the fuck down or you can get the fuck out of here. Like trust I have a weapon on me. I swear to God.
Oh yeah.
And
oh,
you know.
Oh, you're the bride's grandma?
I don't give a fuck. Yeah. Like, bitch, don't talk DNFW. Like, people don't. Like, so it's gonna be a good time.
Can I give you a recommendation on what you should do as part of being an usher?
Yeah, I'll write it down.
All right, So I was in a certain wedding as an usher once.
Okay. I remember. Yeah. I remember very vividly.
I got a flask as a gift.
Yeah.
I thought, I want to start drinking early in the morning.
Yeah.
So I had to think, though. I was like, man, I can't be smelling like booze in a church, though.
Of course you can.
Like, God won't be, don't think that's
the last wedding I was in, Diamond again, I wasn't drinking that time. I was doing this workout thing.
Everybody was
fucked up. Yeah, you were.
Right. Mess and I placing bets, drunk, sitting in the kids.
Everyone was going to cry, right?
Yeah. So, quick story. Sorry to
interrupt. No.
So we're sitting here. You haven't heard this?
No.
Oh, my God.
Do we want to tell this whole thing?
Yeah, because it's a long story. We'll get to it.
All right.
Maybe after this.
Okay. Because I got some shit I want to tell. And I'll fucking drop you on Diamond, that son of a bitch. I just saw him at Wilburn's baby shower. Yeah.
So me and Meston were the ushers.
Yeah.
Shout out to Meston, by the way.
Hey, shouts out. Shouts out, Meston. Twin girls. Yeah.
Him and Keisha.
White girl, by the way.
Yeah, white girl. Yeah,
explain that. Send us an email.
Put some respect on that.
Respect my name. Yeah.
So, anyways, we're like, dude, we gotta get drunk. We gotta do this. Yeah. Like, we can't be smelling like booze, though. You know, Meston's a whiskey drinker. You know.
Oh yeah.
Like fuck it.
Oh yeah.
Let's get a bottle of Kahlua. We'll just say it's coffee. So we went through a bottle of Kahlua.
Yeah.
The whole wedding, him and I.
Like, that's awesome. Like
six flasks each.
I didn't know that. Yeah. That's fucking awesome. Oh yeah.
So it works great.
Yeah.
People smell it on your breath.
Yeah.
I've been drinking coffee. Yeah. Shit, that's Starbucks. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So
Bailey's.
Little Kahlua, awesome. Bailey's. Yep.
Yeah. You know, and for everybody out there, like how it works is, yeah, it's your wedding. It's important. Everybody, you know, whatever. Like when, like I've been in a few weddings, and it's just like, what the fuck? Like maybe I could. It'd be nice to just sit in a wedding,
right?
Enjoy it and get fucked up. Now I'm working it as an usher. I just like I'm gonna try to be nice, you know, because I'm a nice guy. But at the same time, like I don't like people fucking around. And if anybody fucks around,
you're playing on my phone.
That's exactly what you're right.
I'm not saying.
Prince! Oh shit! Oh
shit! Chappelle's show is still on.
Show, yep.
And it is the Prince episode. Rest in peace.
Rest in peace, Prince.
That's so good.
Dropping that purple rain.
You fuck. But yeah, no. So I'm gonna be cool. It's gonna be fun. But yeah, for sure, it's an expensive weekend.
But you
hotels, gifts, tuxes, shoes, shoelaces, and on top of that, I'm there like. Where do you want to sit down? Like, no, seriously, like, there's fucking people waiting. I'm gonna try to be cool, you know? Like, bitch, be cool. If I, you know me. Like, if I gotta pop off, I'll pop off. Like, bitch, no, this ain't happening. You're done.
Yep.
I'll pat people down. Yeah. Whatever I gotta do, you know? If I gotta pull a weapon
in the middle of the mouth, you out.
Yeah,
you
no. You're not gonna be talking.
Bring a whistle.
You're done.
You're done.
No, but what I was gonna say is like, if you ask, you have to know what you're getting in for. If you ask army guys to be in your wedding,
oh yeah,
like, and, or even if you invite them, even if you invite them, you have to know.
Yeah,
I got the invitation in the mail. I was like, is he sure?
Yeah, exactly.
I might ask him and be like, is there anybody you want me to fuck with? Because Harris, I'll do it, man. Like, this dude. Like, I get in his face, and I'll get nose to nose with this dude, and like, what the fuck, who are you again?
Right.
You know, like, just to make people, I like to make people feel uncomfortable. Yeah.
I like to stare at people's ears. See, like this? look at me.
Oh, yeah.
It's just like, what the fuck is he doing?
At first, I'm like, what?
Yeah.
It looks like you got a lazy eye. No, like, yeah, after a second, you're like.
You start talking to people, look at their ear, dude. It freaks them out. They're like. What the fuck is that dude doing, man? Dude, I do that shit all the time.
If I go
to a restaurant and they're taking my order, I'm like, got any hot wings?
I'm gonna
that's good. Yeah, that's good.
They're like, oh, uncomfortable. I'm gonna pay the priest to whoever the fucking person, rabbi, whatever, that reads the fucking mayor shit. to look at both of their ears. Yeah. Looking at their face. When they're reading vows and shit or whatever, we'll pay that motherfucker off.
Yep. Fuck that. He'll take it.
Yeah, they'll take it.
Harris should do that.
They're the church. All they care about is money.
Yeah. as she's reading him her vows, he should stare at her ear. She'd be like, yeah. What's he doing?
We'll pay off Timmy. We'll pay the rabbi. Yeah, it's gonna be awkward. It's gonna be.
I'll put 100 on that right now.
Oh yeah, dude.
That's oh my god, dude. Yeah. Yeah, did you just start doing that out of the blue?
Somebody started doing that to me. I forgot where they started doing that to me, and I was like, I'm fucking taking that. Like, that's just too good.
Were you like, the fuck? Are you looking at?
He didn't. My buddy. I forgot who it was. He just started doing it out of nowhere, and I remember just being feeling really uncomfortable. Just being like,
it is like when you did it here.
Everything goes through your mind. You're like, did I clean my ears this morning?
Yeah. But at first, because you know, they're like, are they looking at my ear? Like, what are they looking at?
Like, that's thinking about like something about Mary. So.
Well, because and everybody knows somebody with the lazy eye. Yeah. Like, and it's. You don't know how to look because you. I look at people in the eye.
Depending on how much of it is. Sometimes, yeah. Like, I think it's sexy. It can be. Like, if it's very slight.
Like on a dude?
No.
I'm just kidding.
Wait, hold on.
Hold on.
Look at this.
Yeah, back up.
Oh, wait, hold on.
Okay, because I kind of agree with you. Because in high school, I had a thing for this chick named Megan. Mm-hmm. And she had.
Shouts out Megan.
I don't know where she's at. She's Armenian chick, but she had kind of a lazy eye.
Yeah.
But hot.
My type of lazy eye, not a wandering eye, not one.
No, it wasn't bad, but I know what you mean.
It's just like a little slight.
Just a little slight, very slight, yeah.
Yeah, I think it's sexy.
Very slight, yeah. Mm-hmm. And that's exactly what I'm talking about.
JPEGs has a little one.
Oh, yeah. Shit.
She doesn't think she does, but like sometimes, especially if she's like tired or like sags a little bit more, it's like, hey, you wanna look at me some more?
Take them pants off, bro. Down.
Yeah.
Sure. No, I mean, I've never seen a girl like that. Oh, you know what? Hold up. But before that, I'm like,
start going through my phone.
You know the people that like, one eye looks forward, the other one looks fucked up. Like I had a doctor like that once.
A doctor?
Yeah, and I don't remember. I think I tore something on my back or something, and
that's why you tore it.
No, but like. Yeah. You can't look at them in the. To me, no, I can't look at them in the face because I don't know if they're like one eye's looking at you, one eye's looking at the wall. You don't know what eye to look at, so I just like instead of looking at them, like I look down.
Right.
I'm just like it's something you're having to. And so for me, I feel like their whole life, if it's bad, not like a slight, if it's bad, their whole life, people are talking to them, like looking down or looking away. Yeah. It's got to be terrible for them.
Yeah, it's got to be horrible.
Right, but they're probably used to it. But I know a few people like that. We got one guy on the job. We call him, I think, Walleye or whatever. Watchtower, whatever.
Watchtower? Oh my God. Jesus.
But like he's like it's I can't I don't like look at him and I don't know what eye to look at. I just
one of my best friends growing up, he had a droopy eye.
Okay.
His eye drooped, you know.
Like a dog. Like a
Like his eyelid drooped. Okay. And his nickname was Sleeps. We used to call him Sleepy. And he was like 5'3".
Yeah.
Yeah. And worst basketball player. You know? Every time on Facebook.
No,
yeah,
don't. Yep. Give
every
him
time, every time on Facebook, there's like a meme that says tag someone who airballs a lot or tag someone who can't shoot.
Yeah.
I haven't talked to this dude in years, but I'll tag him. It happened the other day, actually, you know? Seriously. Yeah. He's one of my best friends growing up. But
awesome.
Sleepy, Sleeps. Yeah. Droopy eye.
Yeah. No, but no, I didn't think about it till this. I just thought about like my interactions with. But there was this broad I went to high school with. I can't remember her name. But she did. Her eye was just a little bit off.
Mm-hmm.
And this is what I think it is. Like you're like, all right. So she's not like 100%. Like if you got to take her down and like tackle her and take it, you can take it. That's what I think it is. No, seriously. Yeah. Like seriously, you're like, okay, she's. It's like the weak, in a group of like deer, right? Like it's like the chicks wear high heels, they stumble, whatever. You're like, oh, okay, that's a soft target.
Right.
They're not going to be able to run. We can take that down. Maybe that's it. Maybe it's something else. I don't know. But
the vulnerability.
Like, no, they're vulnerable. Yeah, like honestly, like I think about this chick.
Pigs.
And I'm like, yeah, I did. I do remember this. I can't remember her name. I probably wouldn't say her name on here, but I don't remember her name. But she did have a slight lazy eye, and it was something attractive about it. That's fucking weird. We're gonna have to look that up. And
not like a really big. JPEGs, like I said, she doesn't claim that she has one, but it's
no,
not.
I've
like
never noticed
she, yeah, like no, it's not.
And I look at her eyes all the time.
While you're holding me down.
No, I've never noticed it. You know?
But and you may not even notice. It's just something that I think. So I enjoy it. Just
fucking great.
That's fucked up. We're gonna edit the last 45 minutes. Then this shit will never go live. Oh Jesus Christ! I wanted to. There's a couple things I want to talk about. I gotta pee. I don't know if. I definitely wanted to get into the 1-2-3 game a little bit because
vicious dude.
At work we had a good one just a couple sets ago. And then I've witnessed some of your experiences. Dude.
I've gotten people with some good ones.
Yeah, of course.
I've had some bad ones I've had to do, but I've been creative with mine.
Okay.
But yeah, go ahead.
Oh, okay. I'll lead off. So at work we got one of our guys assigned was on furlough.
Right.
Which just vacation, so they're gone for the set. Right. So we had a younger guy come in, he's a good dude. But you know, we were fucking with him. We were doing 1-2-3s back and forth, and he's got kind of longer hair, so we're like, we should get him to dye his hair.
Yeah.
Which gets into you a little bit, but we're gonna dye his hair blonde, so he'll look like He-Man. So what we did?
He's got like a tan, like an orange. Yeah.
So what we did was we tried Inception on him. So all for like days we would drop the number 5. So we'd be at the store like shopping for food for the day because we shop. There's 10 of us.
This is a fucking genius.
You motherfuckers planned this?
Yeah. Oh, man. So there's 10 of us at the firehouse. We're fucking close. We eat together. We cook. Yeah. Sleep. Work. We're in stressful environments. We fuck around together. So we're like, we're going to incept this motherfucker. So everything, like, hey, we get on the intercom. Like, hey, we're going in 5 minutes. And we're at the store. We're like, hey, we could get 5 of these for $5 a piece. Every chance we get, we're
saying the number 5.
We're saying the number 5 to him. A couple days later.
Wait, like, this dragged on for days?
This is days, five? Yes.
Because you're on a whole set.
We're, 5 days, 24 hours a day.
Right.
So finally, I think it was me. I think I was like, hey, I'm not going to say his name. Fuck, I'll say his name. Shane. I'm like, Shane, I got 1-2-3-4. He's like, nope. I'm like, what the fuck, man? You haven't even heard it yet, bitch. You know?
It's not even past 5.
Yeah. Just give me 5 minutes of your time. Yeah. You know, like, that'd be worth your while.
Take 5 seconds.
Yeah, come on.
Yeah.
So anyway, he's like, no, I'm not going to do it. You know, we're like, so we're like behind, away from Shane. We're like, what the fuck? Like, how are we going to do it? He never agreed. He's like, oh, I can't do it. I can't dye my hair or whatever. And we're like, you bitch. And then other guys are putting too much pressure on him. And I'm just kind of like, oh, make it look like a setup. Some guys are just like, and some guys are dropping 5 too much. They're just like, 5? Like, no, that's not. Like, dummy, you have to set it up or make it seem not awkward.
Anybody want to go eat 5 guys?
People just weren't doing it right. Yeah. And anyway, he never agreed to count down to dyeing his hair.
Mm-hmm.
But I came up with like a softer challenge or whatever. And I don't remember what it was, but we counted down. He did not say 5. Okay, so the set later, we go to, as a truck, we bring our truck to Walgreens. We got to pick up cold medicine or something. It's not a call. It's just whatever.
Right.
We see these jeggings in Walgreens. And jeggings, for people who don't know.
At Walgreens?
Yeah. Are skin tight, like tights, that look like jeans. They're printed like jeans. Mm-hmm. They got back pockets. Tight as fuck. Like, there might be like
they're 18 yoga inches. Pants.
Yoga
they're
pants. Jeans. Yoga pants that look jeans. Exactly like jeans.
Yeah.
So when you put them on, it looks like you have painted on jeans. So the truck crew, we see that. We're like, yes, we're getting this. We're going to get somebody. We get back to the station. We start 1-2-3-ing people. One of our buddies, Two Guns, he falls victim to the 1-2-3. He has to wear them. And they're tight, and he's a smaller guy. He puts them on. He puts a sock in his fucking junk to make his junk look bigger, but he wears them.
How long did he have to wear them? Was that part of
it? No, he didn't wear them all day.
Okay. I didn't, because he wouldn't be able to work in them. So.
Right. Well, I mean, and we talked about that, and I'm like, well, you got your bunker pants on. If you go into a fire, they're probably not going to melt through your skin. Probably not. If you're if you're in a fire that hot, you're fucked anyway. But right, people right. think that. Like I don't. I wear basketball shorts at night, like under my. And if I'm in something, and people say shit like that, like people that watch or that go to college or read, I don't know. They're like, you got a sticker on your helmet? It's not going to catch on fire? Well, yeah. If I'm dying already, it'll probably catch on fire.
Yeah. Yeah, right.
Or my shorts I have under my bunker pants. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they could melt to my skin if I'm probably dead already.
Right.
I don't know. I'm not a scientist. I'll tell you I am, though. I'm not a guy in gynecologist either.
But I'll take a look.
So anyway, later on in the set, the guy that was on furlough, vacation, he comes in and says, like, hey, what's up? How you guys doing? We're like, oh, fuck, we're doing great. Yeah. It's been a good set. You know, we this and this and this. We got a 1-2-3 for you. And my buddy 1-2-3's him. Motherfucker says 5. And he's a big dude. My buddy Todd, he's a big dude. He's taller than me. He was doing a weight loss competition. He's probably 6'2", maybe taller.
Damn.
And he was... 280. I don't know what he was at the, but he's a bigger dude.
Right.
These pants are maybe 18 inches. They fit him. He's like, he lost. He said lost. 5. And we're like, motherfucker, that was for Shane. Like, 2 seconds ago, what are you doing, but he fell for it. And he put him on. He said, no pictures or whatever, but he put him on. And fuck, he looked good in him. Yeah, it really defines your legs, your fucking quads and shit. But that was great. And they look so good. So, like, they're so tight and they got the pockets. It's like you got to put a can of chew in there to have the ring in there. Fucking
country style.
Yeah. My buddy Two Guns did it. He put boots on and shit. Like, he looked good in them. But that was pretty awesome. Good. But that's the latest one. But
yeah.
Danny, he got so dude. we got to hear this.
Well, Long had got before me.
Yeah. Yeah.
The hair dye.
Yeah, I remember.
The dyes are black.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
and we showed up on a Sunday and he had his hair black.
Oh, no, real quick. Right. So, and sorry, man, I don't mean to interrupt, but one of my favorite things about the 1-2-3 game is because your odds are 1-9.
Right.
And if you don't know what the 1-2-3 game is, I'm not going to explain it. Go back to fucking episode 1, you schmucks. Yeah. So anyway, your chances are bad that you're going to have to do the dare. So yeah. You go, in the Army, we go high on the fire department. We don't get too crazy like we do in the Army, but I could go all day trying to 1-2-3 people and not get anybody.
Right, yeah.
But when somebody gets got, you don't have to be in the same room. You can be down.
They know they got got.
Because everybody goes, oh, shit, yes! And then it's just high five and everybody's hugging. It's incredible.
That's the way it is. So when
Rob got, we were rappelling. We were at SEC Tower in Lincoln, and we were doing rappelling. And there's people on different towers, people on the ground. And
Someone got.
And I don't remember who it was. It might have been Diamond.
Yeah.
That son of a bitch. I don't remember, but they're like, you got to dye your hair jet black. And he's like, okay. And they count off. And when anytime this happens, especially if it's a good one.
Good one. People fucking.
And they say the same number. As soon as it happens, the person who loses, I've been there. They're like, oh, what? And you're like, you don't believe it. And everybody else goes, oh! And they fucking high five and go crazy. That's my favorite part. So even if you're not there, because I've been in other rooms.
Oh, yeah, for
but
sure.
But as soon as you hear everybody applaud, like, fucking we landed on the moon again.
For sure.
You're like, oh, who got God? What happened? What was it? Yeah. Like, what was it?
And then once the other person suit, ask him. Yeah.
So I got God in Wisconsin. After Long, I got guy with his black hair.
Jet black, jet black. I was a part of helping him dye.
Right. Yeah. My original one was, I had to dye my hair blonde.
Yes.
Bleach fucking blonde. Well, for all the listeners out there who never seen me in person, I'm not a light-skinned dude.
He's a sexy motherfucker.
I got that.
Puerto Rican zombie, bitch.
There you go.
I mean, it's kind of gross, but whatever.
Yeah, fuck you, too. So we went to the local store there at the... Fort McCoy,
okay.
And they didn't have any blonde.
No,
they didn't have it. So we had to get the next best thing,
which was Beyonce red.
Which, so, I mean, you have dark hair.
I have dark hair. It didn't look bad.
No, but still, you could, you knew it wasn't your natural hair color.
It was not my natural hair color.
Because I saw the
It was pictures. Like J-Lo and Sinbad had a fucking kid. Like, seriously, like, it was bad.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, it didn't look bad, but you could tell it wasn't my natural hair.
Yeah.
And so, I fucking lost. And it, at first, it's funny because I uploaded a picture. Because Long actually did it. He's the one who did it.
Yeah.
He dyed my hair.
He's the one who got you, too.
He's the one who got me, too. Okay. He got me, and he's dyed my hair. I took a picture of us, like a selfie, like him dyeing my hair. But I didn't realize, like, our shirts are off. We're, like, in a shower. We had shorts on and stuff. But it just looked like two naked dudes standing right in front of each other, like in a shower. And one just has like shampoo in his hair, you know?
So I had to take that picture and I'm like, that looks really, really weird. But I had to dye my hair. I was a ginger. Yeah. I didn't have a soul for a few months.
You look good, dude.
Yeah, you kept it.
I kept it too. Yeah. I rocked it because the birds loved it.
Oh, the birds loved it, dude. The chick we met from... She was from Miami. She was in that.
Oh, yeah.
You guys look like brother and sister.
Yeah, she had like red hair too, yeah.
She was Dominican. Forgot about that. Maybe.
Yeah. They're from the Miami unit. Yeah.
They came down to watch us train.
Right. Well, that game is just like the countdown is just, it's the best part.
It's intense, man.
It's intense.
If you're on the other end of that, you get nervous.
I got Engelman in Chicago.
Oh, shit.
So Engelman does this thing. I don't know if you've seen it, but he twitches his eyes really funky. Like creepy. Like just, he'll look at you and he'll start twitching both of his eyes really weird. And I'm like, Engelman, you got to go up to somebody and ask them for directions. And it's got to be my choosing. All
right.
Well, he still hasn't done it yet, so I'm waiting. But
He lost.
He's got to do it still.
What the fuck, Engelman? You son of a bitch.
Yeah. So he lost. But I've had some good ones. The best one, I think, because I just thought of it like that.
Yeah.
So we had a new guy join the unit. He came to drill once. Then he wasn't there the next month for drill because he was having a baby.
Okay.
And so he had added a few of us on Facebook.
Okay.
So we, he added a few of us on Facebook.
I know exactly what this is.
Well, I got not.
Yeah.
I got not in the 1, 2, 3 because not, he came up to us like, hey, look, old boy had his baby.
Yeah.
And he showed us pictures of it. And so we really didn't know him that well.
No.
So I was like, not, you got to change your profile picture to his baby. You know how awkward that is?
That
if you don't know
awkward,
somebody
man.
And then they see your profile picture is their newborn baby.
Yeah. Yes. Yep.
And he lost.
He lost, yeah.
Yep. So
that.
So he had to change his profile picture. And you know us, dude. We're on there liking it. Looks just
making
like
comments.
You. Yep. Yeah. Didn't know you were having a baby and stuff like that, dude.
Yep.
And he was like, fuck, dude, everyone's calling me. Everyone's texting me.
I don't remember what the agreement was, but he didn't fulfill the agreement.
No.
But I understand.
I understand, right. But he still kept it for a few hours.
Yeah, he did.
And it was great for those few hours.
Yeah, he did.
Because, like I said, people had no idea. The dude whose actual baby it was messaged him and was like, dude, why is your profile picture of my newborn baby?
Yeah, plus his parents are like, is there something you didn't tell me? His girlfriend's like, what the fuck is going on? Like, that was great.
Yeah,
that was great.
Great.
I remember that. That was
great.
Yeah,
that was good.
I want to say another good thing about Pushcompton.
Yeah.
So
Wisconsin.
Wisconsin. So we're in this barracks, and it was shitty. So,
fuck that place.
Yeah, fuck that place. They fucked it up. We were kind of split up. We had to move twice, and then, so there was like a small amount of us in one barracks.
This was last year.
Last year, and then the rest of the barracks was some other unit. We didn't know them. We didn't talk to them. We were just kind of like, you're with us, you know. Didn't know about the 1-2-3 game. They would just observe us doing shit like
playing cards of humanity.
Play like the captain. It was this captain.
Ernest goes to camp.
Yeah. So like this is the shit. Like so they're in our we're in our barracks and we're doing shit like somebody lost 1-2-3 game had to buy a disc set that had like all the Ernest movies. Ernest goes to camp. Ernest goes to court. Ernest goes or jail.
Right.
Ernest goes scared stupid. We're watching that on a projector like every day. No, guys are sleeping on the floor. Like, I don't need my bunk. I'm sleeping on the floor because I lost in 1-2-3 game. They're just thinking, what the fuck weirdo. Is this?
Dude, we're dying. In, right, dying yeah,
so,
hair.
So this captain, he seemed like a good dude. This black dude, he's a captain. He was in charge of the unit. He comes over. We're playing Cards Against Humanity on our bunks. He's like, what is this? Well, that was Cards Against Humanity. You know, check it out. It's fun. And he's watching. Like, the next hand that gets played is like the winner was like three dicks at the same time or something. He kind of shakes his head and walks away. A couple days later, like three of us are in the shower together.
Dying.
Danny's hair. That dude comes in to take a shower. He's got his towel. Same thing. Like, yeah. He shakes his head.
Kinda
like,
you already remember what he said?
No.
He goes, damn, I've seen some things in the army. Yeah. God damn.
Yeah.
Like, he's like, I've seen some things, but what the fuck is going on?
These guys had to have been like, these guys from Nebraska are crazy. Seriously fucked up.
Because they didn't see the 1-2-3 game.
Right? No.
They just saw the results.
They just saw the results.
They just saw us watching Ernest movies every night on the projector, dyeing each other's hair, putting on fucking yoga pants or whatever, and sleeping on the floor.
Old boy having a sleep in a thong.
Yeah. Tarzan had sleep in a thong. He's doing, and not only did he sleep in, he's doing like squats in the middle of a barracks with all men. He's doing squats. Like, just weird shit. They had to have been like, I'm never going to go to Nebraska.
Yep.
That's the best.
I think it was you. No, I don't know if it was you. Somebody got kudlots with the do-rag.
The do-rag.
That was actually one of the funniest. Kudlots is one. He's got one of the weirdest shaped heads in the world.
Oh, my God. He's like alien. Yeah. Kulats, yeah. He's a fucking weird dude.
He looks
dude.
Like the Patriot symbol. Like, he had to wear this do-rag.
Yeah.
And he had, like, the biggest grin on his face with this big old head.
Dude, I know.
Walking around this water park, and, like, he's walking around, and he finally owned it. Was like, fuck it.
Yeah, he just owned it, man.
Fuck it. And it like,
it was no great. Bad
not. Yeah, it was great.
It was great. So, we brought this up on the podcast, and you know what? Carlin had to wear those red yoga pants
with a thong.
At the water park. And that was funny. But Kudlots had to wear a white do-rag. And yeah, he's like, we split up into different groups. And I remember just walking next to Kudlots. And he had the white do-rag on. He's smiling, like, acting like he's not wearing it. He looked fucking ridiculous.
He looked ridiculous. It was all loose. It wasn't even
on. He's a white dude.
Everybody's looking at him. He's like, I don't.
It was so good. It hit a point in time where I got Kudlots on the right. Me and Carlin's left, right? But we're in the lazy river, and Carlin's in the lazy river with the two, and his thong's all the way high up his ass.
People are pointing.
This little kid, he's with his mom and his sister. Yeah. This little boy goes, Mom, what is that? And she goes, ask your dad. She goes, what kind of swimsuit is that? Like, ask your dad. Oh man, that's great.
That was great. He was a good sport about it, man.
Yeah.
He was rocking the fuck out of it. Like, he didn't have it on. Like, he didn't have it on. Just,
yeah,
he didn't give a fuck. Right. I'm just like,
he owned that shit. Yeah, he owned the fuck out of it. That's my dude. Shout out, Kudlots. Yeah.
Shout out, Kudlots, you son of a bitch.
He's still young enough to be in the army, right? Like, he's still in the units and stuff.
Yeah.
I didn't know if he had transferred out or anything like that.
Oh, if he was smart, he would have been that smart. If I had a lower score of MEPS.
Yeah, that's fucking great.
Yeah, 1-2-3 game. Hit us up for ideas. nastyandfriends@gmail.com. We will fucking take your ideas and we will fucking hurt people with those ideas if we can.
Yeah.
Moving off of 1-2-3. So, like, for me, in back in 06, I was going through paramedic school and YouTube started really going.
Yeah.
And then since then, YouTube is one of my favorite things. Like, that's. Like, I cancel cable. I talk about it every fucking podcast.
Yeah.
I'm just happy I did it. I'm still on YouTube every day. But back then, with the Army and then paramedic school for me, just getting into YouTube, I think it was fucking a great idea. It's still one of the best ideas for the internet. Do you guys have any favorite YouTube videos or new YouTube videos you want to talk about?
Yes. I got a YouTube video. Courtesy of Pac Nasty 35 of myself getting pretty much raped.
It's 32, bitch.
Yeah, whatever the fuck it is, dude.
I'm just messing with that. It's 32.
Is it 32 or 35?
No, Vito's.
Vito's 35?
It's 35. Okay. Yeah, that's where you're.
34 and a half. of me getting raped by an old lady. An 80-year-old lady.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Right?
So what happened was I made YouTube videos for a little bit. I still have some of them up. As shit. It was a lot of fun. It's great. But we went out.
Yeah.
If I remember right, I think it was for Wilburn's birthday party.
Birthday.
I think I'm almost positive it was Wilburn's birthday party. Right. His girlfriend set it up, invited all of us. We're all together. Right. We went to Dueling Pianos here in fucking cities.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's Brewskies. Yeah.
Yep.
So we did the fucking Dueling Pianos, and then I don't know.
This old lady just came out of nowhere.
Yeah, like out of left field. She was fucking gone.
Dude, she was literally like in her 70s.
Nice.
Yeah.
I mean, her husband was there, and no bullshit, no joke. Her husband was on like an oxygen respirator.
Nice. Yeah.
With like a walker.
So he's not a problem.
No, yeah. And so she comes and sits on my lap in front of everybody out of fucking nowhere. And she's like, hey, sweetie.
The darkest one there.
Yeah. Well, it was funny because she sits on my lap and I'm all, oh, dude, I'm like, what the fuck? And she's like, what's your name, sweetheart? Blah, blah, blah.
Real quick, were you boned up or no?
What I like to think about
I won't
is,
admit that publicly on podcast radio.
What I think about is because for half of a second, you know he was excited. Like,
And so, like, sitting on my lap, and she's, you know, just flirting, whatever. And I'm like, you know, she's like, you got a girlfriend? And I was like, yeah, I got a girlfriend. I didn't at the time. And I was like, I was like, I do have a girlfriend.
Yeah.
I was like, she's actually on her way here.
Yeah.
Just so she can get off my lap.
Yeah.
She finally gets off my lap and I move to the other side of the table because she goes back to her table and she keeps staring at me.
Okay.
And she keeps giving me these looks and she's like dancing, drinking, you know, giving me these looks. Yeah. And I'm like, damn, dude, like I gotta get the fuck out of here.
Yeah.
So I move to the other side of the table. Well, I'm at the other side of the table where she can't see me. Of course, she comes back and what does she ask? She goes up. I don't know if it was you, but she was like, where's your dark friend?
That's right. Yeah, yeah, it was like, me. Yeah.
And guess what? Guess what they all do?
What?
They point right at me, dude. They point
of course,
right
at me,
dude. Right? Then the piano
I'll
guy.
I'll take you to him. Get on my get on my shoulders.
Yeah, yeah.
Get your walker. We're going.
Yeah, I'll push you.
Yeah. The piano guy is like sees what's going down. Mm-hmm. So he calls us up, dude. He calls us up. So we get up to the front of the pianos, and she just starts grinding on me.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah, oh yeah. Dirty. That's the video style that I have.
So this motherfucker takes a video of it.
Yeah.
Of her, like, grinding on me. I mean, seriously. Like, she smelled like mothballs when she was that old. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, it was bad.
Yeah.
And, like, I'm pretty sure when she was grinding, I could hear, like, her diaper smushing. You know? Like, her hips
arthritis. Crepitus.
Yep. Anyway, I was a good sport. And she tried to kiss me too. She tried. Yeah. She had pulled my head in and like moved away. Yeah. You know, and
it's fucking.
And she caught the edge of my lip a little bit, and it's kind of gross. I'm never gonna forget that.
I love it. But anyway, so that part, it's got
like 300 views. Yeah. It's shutting the fucking internet down. Yeah, you know,
like 250 are yours.
Yeah. I swear to God. Yep.
It's good. So we'll look it up.
We'll look it up for sure. Another one that we all loved was obviously the fucking my new haircut.
My new haircut. That was one of the ones that started it for me.
It really was.
Yeah. And Army was big.
It was big, dude. I mean, Jager bombs.
And they had Heineken so many Jager bombs.
Yeah. Oh, dude, none of them were as good as the original. Yeah.
We dressed up like them and went out one night because the Harris and I were.
That's right. I remember that. Yes, we did. Yes, I forgot about that.
Sunglasses. It was fucking. It was Guido night, yo.
Yeah,
it's fucking awesome.
Yeah, if you don't know about my new haircut, fucking. It's probably 10 years ago. Check it out. It's probably not as funny now, but back then, it was great. I listened to it 100 times.
Yeah.
Real quick before we move on, because I love YouTube and I want to keep moving on to that. Going back to this old broad, do you ever reconsider not fucking taking her down?
You know what, man? I started thinking when I left. I was like,
no, honestly.
She probably had money, dude.
No, not about that. it should be because we started it off with
hell yeah.
We did start it off with fuck bitches get money.
But yeah.
What I'm thinking is, like my experience, like say in the last 5 years, whatever. Right. Like, okay, so having sex with like a 22-year-old,
right?
Having sex with like a
88-year-old?
No. Like, say a 44-year-old, yeah, or whatever. Like, yeah, double the age,
right?
Is way better. Like, and I like MILFs.
Yeah,
you know, I do like MILFs. So like, yeah, it's way fucking better with the woman who knows how to take care of someone, right, and whatever. Right. So double that. Go from 44 or 88. Go from 40 to 80. She might have fucking. Yeah. It might have been fucking amazing.
I could have been King Dingling.
Oh my god, dude! Yeah, like, you think? No, honestly, dude. Like, been. I'm not like. Yeah, you're playing football, or you're a boxing coach.
Right.
You fight somebody 20.
Right.
You fight somebody 80. You're fucking beating the shit out of 80.
Right. Right.
But let's talk about 60 years of sexual experience. Okay? That might have been. You know what I'm saying?
I know exactly, you know what, I'm saying, mean, what I mean.
Like, she might have been. You might have been like.
That's what I'm saying. I,
she's like the Yoda or whatever. Like,
be sexy. Honestly, what it comes down to, I wasn't old enough to know better than
that. Yeah.
So it didn't really cross my mind then.
Yeah.
So now that you explain it like that.
Yeah.
I wish she was here right now.
Her husband's like, just get out there. Yeah, yeah. Take her away from me.
Her husband's dead, dude.
Yeah, no, he's dead. Yeah. No, but yo, if you're listening.
If you're listening. I don't. Her name's probably Ethel.
Ilgrid.
You know? Marge, you know? Marge.
Yo, if you're listening and you remember our brown friend, hit us the fuck up. We will set you up with a meeting. We're not guaranteeing sex. Yeah. We'll set you up for sure with a meeting with them and sit down.
Yeah.
Go over the terms.
We have all the terms.
We're recording.
We're
recording.
We're, you know, we can play bingo. We can have dinner at 4 o'clock. Yeah. You know, I'm cool with it all. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, just make sure if you're going missionary style, you move the life alert out of the way.
It's gotta be missionary. Jesus. I think that's not old. They don't
understand. Sorry, man. I've been sitting on that fucking one for like 3 minutes, dude. I've been waiting to drop it because I knew that's where he was gonna take it.
Oh man,
dude. Oh, there's something to be said. There's something to be said about experience. Is all I'm saying.
Yeah, no.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
that's good. You showed me the dramatic chipmunk.
Oh my god, that was a classic.
Yeah, I mean, those are like old classics. Yeah. YouTube came out in
that's
05.
The big.
Yeah,
that's
05,
the best.
I think
6 seconds of the internet. That's
oh my god,
after.
That was so
dramatic
good,
chipmunk.
Dude.
Oh, that's fucking.
And
great.
Then what I love is like you get dramatic chipmunk comes out,
yeah,
it blows up, and then you start getting remixes, and some remixes are fantastic, some remixes are just shit, like
just shitty,
just people want attention or whatever. But yeah, dramatic chipmunk.
The Will Arnett sex tape was great.
Will Arnett.
That's
sex
one
tape.
Of the best. That's top
one
five.
Of my favorites.
That's
one. Of my
yeah,
favorites.
That's one of the, it's top five.
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
really YouTube videos ever.
Yes.
And it's funny because my army boys, we watch it, we giggle like fucking.
Yes.
I show this to other people, and they're looking at me like. You think this is funny?
No, I've had the same thing.
Right? Like, you're like, what do you think is funny, dude?
Where are you from? Like, yeah, when you show somebody something like that, and they're like, I don't get it, it just
seriously.
Makes me like.
If you don't get a pant full of bone watching that,
where the fuck are you from? Like, I don't know why I know you.
Right.
Lose my number.
Yeah, lose my number. Don't call me, I'll call you.
The German dude, the fucking. Techno Viking.
Oh, Techno Viking. Yes, Techno Vikings don't.
I don't think they. I think they took that off.
I think they did.
No,
they did.
Because
all
they.
One of my buddies that I follow on Instagram, he's really funny, makes funny videos. He just actually came out with a video. A Techno Viking video.
No shit.
Yeah, and it's great. I love it. So look up L_EE Instagram. Funny videos.
So we're opening up contraband and passing around. We're not gonna tell you what it is. It's just contraband.
Anyways,
because I don't know, there was some fucking type of, like I said, it was, they took it off for some fucking legal shit. I don't know what it was for. And it's like one of the best, dude.
I do remember looking for it a few years ago and couldn't find it. Mm-hmm. But I'm sure people put put it back on there, but you know, because back then it had millions of views, and then when it comes back on, it has like, you know, a small amount of views, and then it gets taken down. I don't know why it gets taken down, but that was, it was fucking great.
Yeah.
There were so many, and now there's still good videos now.
It's hit or miss now, man.
But there's so many. There's so much more.
There's so much more content,
which is great. I mean, I love YouTube. You know how much I love YouTube. Oh, I could talk fucking YouTube all day.
And I see something gold. What I think is gold, I tried to send it out to people.
Right.
Back then, the Tourette's guy was big.
Oh yeah,
the Tourette's guy was fucking huge.
Yeah, that was great.
We still quote him.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, we still quote Tourette's
fuck
guy.
Fuck salt, dude. Yeah. I got it on my tablet, dude. Sometimes, you know, so people out there don't know, I run a boxing gym. And so when I have like my team training, my athletes, I plug my tablet in and have music playing. Well, on my tablet, I got all these small sound bits. Nice. I got like Family Guy sound bits. I got Step Brother sound bits. So like when I hit the S's, right? For some reason, it just falls under the S's. All right. Like it'll play like Sublime, Santeria.
Okay.
As soon as the song's over, you'll hear, fuck salt! People would be like, what the fuck is that? I'm like, that's Tourette's guy. You know about Tourette's guy?
Yeah. That's so fucking
my athletes
genius.
Are like, what the fuck is that, dude? Yeah. And like, you have the weirdest shit on your fucking tablet, man.
And if you don't know about the Tourette's guy, check him out. Like, YouTube. Some people just get into YouTube late, whatever.
Yeah.
YouTube had gold from day one. And yeah, it was a smaller group. Now everybody posts fucking shit on YouTube.
There's a lot Nasty of and Friends.
Oh, half of that material is fucking garbage. Tourette's guy is so fucking good. And he's an internet legend. People said he died. People are trying to find out who he really
died,
was.
Right.
Rumors that he died. And then people were like, he's not dead. And but he stopped making videos years ago. But fucking all of them were so fucking funny.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
I called her a bitch right in front of her tits. Yeah. Trying to walk a mile in my shit.
That's not Mickey Mouse, it's tit dirt. Yeah.
Fuck Tourette's guy.
Yeah.
Charlena.
Yeah, Charlena. You bitch.
I'm not a bitch. I'm your wife.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Oh, shit. after we recorded,
the best is the bird. The bird that comes in his house. Yeah.
Oh my God!
And it's just like he has like a. I know we're like the voice that we're doing, and like his is usually a higher pitched voice when he yells.
Yeah.
Like I feel it's.
Yeah. Charlena. Oh shit!
Yeah. Oh, but I just want to say to everyone out there, I've been trying to spread this. It ain't a bad thing either.
Herpes.
Put your dick back. You got
the word bird.
You've heard it at this point. It's been 100 times. Yes.
So people think the word bird is a bad thing.
No.
Bird just means girl, right? It's just another word for a girl.
Okay.
You can have good birds. You can have bad birds.
Okay.
So it's just a way for me and my buddies have been classifying girls.
Yeah. And you have a
I have a legit.
It's legit.
Yeah, like it. You
have
know,
it.
Yeah, right. You're gonna and break so it down. Like I'll break it down.
Okay.
Notepads. Get your notepads.
Notepads out, everybody. Time, listening. Bitches. There's a hot redhead around. Damn, you see that cardinal over there? You know.
Yeah.
You see a white trash chick. That's a seagull.
Is this something that you guys came up with?
That's just something I've been coming
this
up
is,
with.
Yeah, this is all Danny. This is all Danny.
A goth chick. That's a raven. A dead chick is a crow. Your main girl, right? That's your American bald eagle.
Okay.
You know, your fat chicks are your turkeys.
Yeah.
Skinny chicks are your flamingos.
Yeah.
Short, thick chicks are your hummingbirds. You know, I can go all day.
No, I know
what I'm saying?
I know. I've
and heard. So, it ain't a bad thing. You know what I'm saying? So all the dudes out there, you know, this is a good way to classify these girls out there. You know what I'm saying? Crazy girls are your cuckoo birds. Your lesbians are your roosters.
Yeah.
You know, I mean.
See, I didn't know that you had all those classifications. I knew you called him like a bird, and I figured more of a reason. But
he's got more.
I got it down.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? It's just a fun way for me to.
Yeah, that's pretty funny, though. I mean, it's sexist as fuck, but I enjoy it.
This is a fun way to beat down women even more in a society where men are better than women.
Hey, our brains are bigger. It's science.
Their brain is a fraction of a size of ours.
Jeez. Shout out to Ron Burgundy. For real, man.
Yeah, shouldn't
have done that second movie, though.
Dude, as many podcasts as we've done, we have never given a shout out to Ron Burgundy. Thank you for that.
Yeah.
Hit us up, Ron.
Ron,
if you're listening,
Champ, Kind Sports.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
All of them, the whole crew.
Baxter.
Hit
us the fuck up.
Yeah.
You know where to find us. We're not even gonna tell you. You know where to find us on the fucking interwebs.
Yeah. You know what I like about Baxter? He reminds me of Charlie Kelly. Very true.
How much cheese is too much cheese?
Right.
So let's let's unless you want to elaborate more on our bird watching.
Nah.
let's we every episode we talk about Always Sunny.
I love it.
I know you do.
I love it.
I know you're just as big a fan as us.
Oh yeah.
Favorite episode?
It's probably the Christmas episode.
Oh my god! Yeah, yes.
Fucking Charlie fucking bites Santa Claus's neck.
Yeah, right. I don't know if you brought that up on the podcast.
No, we haven't.
You fuck my mom. You fuck my mom.
I love that episode.
Yes,
I love that episode.
Do you know what season that's in?
Six or seven.
Yeah, yeah, six. Say that. I thought it's the final episode of one of the seasons. Right. I want to say it's right around six.
I love that episode. I think it's great. I like when they try returning the toy to their buddy they stole, that Max stole the toy from. Yeah, yeah. It was like, dude, just take the apology. And they try to give him the bloody shirt at the end, you know? That's a classic episode. Yeah. I just watched the season that came on Netflix, and I love the Family Feud one.
Mm. Yeah, that was that
one was fucking great. That was great. I also like where they They're trying to find old boy, their real dad, but they find the wrong dude.
Yeah,
and they blow up his car. Yeah, and Charlie's like, wild card, bitches.
That's the oil one, right?
The gas crisis.
Is that the gas crisis? And then they kind of redo that. Trash crisis.
Yes. Those episodes are fucking great.
Yes.
And then you know where Max sleeps with Dennis's mom.
Yes.
Everyone starts sleeping with everybody. Yeah.
That one's.
And what I like about the show is they stay true to themselves. Like, I love The Office. The Office is one of my favorite shows. Yeah. But I feel like those last few episodes, it got away from what made The Office funny. Like, the originality just wasn't there.
No.
Like, bringing Will Ferrell on, it was like they were just trying too hard.
They're trying too
hard. Yeah, you know? And so, what I like about Sunny Philadelphia is they stay true to themselves.
Absolutely.
You know? Yeah. And, like, throughout the whole fucking thing they do.
Yeah.
You know? And you know that by never knowing the waitress's name.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, I fucking love that.
I love it too.
I love that. And like how Maureen Ponderosa can come back and they're still talking about her dead fucking tooth. Like, it's shit like that.
Yeah.
Like,
they just signed three more seasons.
Did they really? Yeah. Like,
that's going to keep going. Man.
Yeah.
And talking about The Office, that goes back. This is like the fifth time we brought up Whiny, that son of a bitch.
Yeah.
Whiny kept talking about The Office. Kept talking about The Office. I'm like, fuck, okay,
I'll watch it, yeah.
We met at the Donut Professor on 72nd Street in like 08, 09. He gave me like the first five seasons of it. I watched it, and then I was hooked, and then I started watching it. But yeah, the end of it, I thought it was a great show.
Yeah, it was a great show.
I liked a lot of the characters. At the end of it, I'm just like, just fucking end it.
You just, right.
But Always Sunny was also something I didn't watch from the beginning, but I caught up. And yeah, that's completely different. Way better.
Charlie Kelly is Charlie Kelly all the way through.
Yes.
Dwight Schrute is a fucking dork in the beginning.
Yeah.
Then he becomes like, owns the building and, you know.
Assistant to the company.
Yeah, you know, and it's just like.
Yeah,
everyone's the same, you know, and it's like that's what I love about. I mean, I love The Office
for network TV.
Yeah,
The Office was good,
great,
but it's not competing with
no
shit you have on cable, or,
right?
Yeah, yeah,
right. I mean, the dry humor is great.
Yeah,
I was a big fan of Curb Your Enthusiasm. Just get the dry humor, Larry David. That's one. That's probably actually my favorite show of all time.
I only watched. Two seasons
ago. Right.
I thought it was.
It's got 10 seasons.
Fucking fantastic.
Oh, it's got 10 seasons.
It's Showtime?
HBO.
Like HBO. Okay.
HBO. It's great.
Fan fucking
fantastic. And if for people that don't know what it is, Larry David was the creator of Seinfeld, him and Jerry Seinfeld. And
like
he.
Seinfeld.
Yeah. Some never Jewish dude. Like your tongue. And so Larry David created his own show on HBO called Curb Your Enthusiasm. And the reason it's so great is because half the show is improv.
Yeah.
So he'd write a script on a scene. And then, like, the second half of the scene was just kind of improv.
Yeah.
And Larry just found himself in these funny, crazy situations where the humor was just great.
Who's the black dude? From
Leon. Leon.
Okay, yeah.
In the show, Larry adopts a family called the Blacks. Their last name is Black. And they were a family that got relocated from the Hurricane Katrina disaster. Well, they show up at his house, and then their brother shows up.
And when they first meet, Larry's like, hold on. Your last name is Black? They're like, yes. They're like, that's like if my last name was Jew. Like, you know, and he just blows his mind. But fucking Leon shows up at the door and he's like, who are you? And he's like, oh, I'm Leon. Yeah. I'm Loretta's sister. He's like, were you in the hurricane? Nah, I just live in LA. I'm coming to stay with y'all. And him and Larry become best friends. Yeah. And it's the greatest fucking thing ever.
Those guys are fucking great. And that's one of the best things about the show. Right. It's not scripted or whatever. No, they just give them ideas and then they just improv, and that makes it
and that's so great acting.
Good. It just makes it so good. And then you have to have talented people to do that.
Oh yeah. And if you watch that show,
Larry David is a funny motherfucker.
Oh, Larry David is hilarious.
I
love Larry.
I think him and Bernie Sanders might be the same person.
Yeah.
That's another topic.
Right.
We'll go. But no, Curb Your Enthusiasm is fucking great.
And if
great.
You watch some of the earlier episodes, like Meredith from The Office and Oscar from The Office, they're in Curb Your Enthusiasm. Okay. They have like smaller roles here and there, you know? Okay. So The Office actually Curb Your Enthusiasm actually gave way to a lot of actors.
Yeah.
To bigger roles. But I actually read something interesting last year where the Curb Your Enthusiasm actually saved a man's life. Jeez. So this guy got convicted of murdering somebody in LA, okay. right? And he was as he's on trial, he's like, I didn't fucking do it.
Yeah.
I wasn't even there. And they're like, well, can you prove you weren't there? And he goes, well, maybe. He said, when I was at a Dodger game when this happened, he goes, and I remember there was cameras everywhere. They were like filming a TV show.
Was it the episode with when
the hooker, the black hooker, he takes her to the Dodger game.
Well, I was thinking of the player that missed the ball. Never mind.
I didn't see the black hooker
episode.
Right.
I want to see it.
That's a great one.
Wearing a black hooker.
Right. Well, Larry gets tickets to a Dodger game.
Okay.
And he can't find anybody to go with him. And there's too much traffic. But the carpool lane is open. So he picks up a fucking hooker.
To get into the carpool lane. We've all been there.
Right. Yeah. Yeah, we've all been there. Yeah. Well, they go back and look at the footage. And sure enough, old boy is in the fucking stands, dude.
No shit.
Gets off for murder.
Good. Yep. Good. That's fucking awesome.
Yep. So it's fucking crazy. It's crazy. That's a great show.
They had another episode with I don't follow baseball, but they go back and with the guy that missed the ball or whatever. It was like he's like a famous baseball dude.
Oh, Bucky Dent. Yeah.
Yeah, I think so. And he was on there. Anyway, great show.
Yeah, great.
Fucking funny shit. Larry David is fucking hilarious.
And Larry, man. Great writer.
Or Bernie Sanders, whoever that dude is.
Yeah.
Fucking great.
Right.
Great show.
Yeah, I love it.
Always Sunny. I got a favorite character that's not a regular.
Cricket.
And that is, well, no, Cricket. Nah, Cricket is good. The hooker.
Yes. Yeah, I'm gonna marry that whore.
Yeah, I'm gonna make that whore my wife. Roxy.
Roxy, yes.
Roxy was one of the best characters. I don't think we ever brought this up in the podcast. Roxy was one of the best characters. It was my Pretty Woman episode.
Yeah.
I wanna say season 8.
Something like that.
It was the first episode of one of the seasons. And they did a whole Pretty Woman deal. Frank was gonna marry her. D and Dennis start smoking crack again, and they go shopping. Like, Roxy's doing fucking foot fetish porn or whatever.
What does she call the dude at the store?
Oh,
when he's trying to kick her out, she calls him like dick breath.
Then
she pulls out that.
Yeah, she's putting on the jacket.
Yeah, she's putting on the jacket.
She's like. She's spilling vodka on the
jacket.
The jacket.
Like, it's like a $2,000 jacket.
Yeah. And I can't remember what she calls. She calls him something good. But she was fucking great. And then she dies at the end of the episode.
Yeah.
She overdoses and they're just like, we'll just put her in the hallway. And we'll keep going. And then they play the Pretty Woman music. And Frank, of course, is like, you know, I was going to marry that whore. But whatever. We'll keep going. But I always hope. And
she comes back?
Yeah, that she comes back like she wasn't dead. She was such a good character.
Yeah.
So I just think of that.
I like when fucking Frank hops out in the skinny jeans. You know? And he's like, you got that Humpty Dumpty feeling?
Because Danny DeVito's so oddly shaped.
Yeah. Dude, like when he chops out of that couch.
There's a man in that couch. Like, I don't think you could have a better casting call for that show.
No.
For Frank, at least.
No.
For Frank.
No.
That's perfect, man. I mean, because it's just... you wouldn't expect that from Danny DeVito to be just like, you remember when they're playing that, when Dee's playing that video game and Charlie starts playing it, gets her all these followers and stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
And then Frank gets on the fucking intercom and he's like, I got these peaches. And he's like, a mouthful of fucking peaches and it's just peach juice all over. I mean, just the big old nasty sleaze. It's,
oh, yeah.
Yeah, I fucking love it. Yeah.
Like the intervention episode when he's fucking trying to bang Gale's
bury that on. Motherfucker. In the beginning, up.
Yeah.
Smushing it. You're smushing it. You're not even doing it right.
He's like, What was that line? Max like something. He's like, oh, it's awful. We just drank a bunch of Monster Energy drinks and dry humped it.
It was awful.
Nene's like, you're not even giving me a hand job. You're just mashing it right
now. Mashing it right now.
But people we talk to, you know, Pags, right. Spencer, they're all like, same way I am. I'm like, Charlie Kelly was my favorite character. Yeah. And then it's just like fucking Frank, Danny DeVito. It's just,
oh, dude, he's great.
He's right up there. He might be my favorite character. Yeah. He's unbelievable. 77 years old.
Yeah, and I think it's more, I think with him, it's, I mean, obviously you love the character because of who plays him, but it's just like, it's Danny DeVito playing that character. Which
like a legit, one of the great actors. You know what I
mean? Seriously, yeah. And then when Charlie's on his date and he can't save philanthropist, and he's got just fucking his... He's got the meat sweats gone, the cheese sweats gone, you know? And he's like, I'm a full-on rapist.
Yes, yes.
She's like, excuse me? And he's like, yeah, old men, little boys, everybody. She's like, what did you just say? I'm a full... Are you trying to say you're a philanthropist? Yes, that's the word.
Yeah, oh my God.
Yeah, I love that. Yeah. Yeah. And then when Dee and Dennis are taking Frank out to dinner... And they're like, they're trying to tell him big news.
Yeah.
And he's like, you two aren't banging, are you? He's like, that's disgusting. And they're like, we're not banging my sister. Like, really loud in the fucking restaurant. And I love that, dude.
They always go back to that one fancy restaurant.
Yeah. Regino's.
Yeah.
Regino's,
yeah. Man.
You're the best restaurant in Philadelphia. Yeah. You know? I don't want to sit on a book of matches.
That episode when they're fucking, I still got... Sorry, man. I still got the meme where is Charlie and Mac
looking at each other. Yeah.
And then the cream pie episode, they go back. There so many different times.
So many times, dude.
That's fucking great. Yeah,
I just love how they stay true.
They stay true to themselves. Yeah. And like shows are rarely like that anymore.
No, fuck.
You know, and it's like, I think it's great. Like I said, The Office kind of lost their touch there at the end.
Yeah.
But Sunny in Philadelphia has it.
I think they have freedom. Where they could, they could just
write,
and they don't have
right. Like, and I'm not sure, like The Office had the same writers all the way through.
No, they probably didn't.
You can tell you got
people that blow up, they go do different things or whatever. And then it's just like, let's just keep this going and
right. Like I think if The Office ended like season 7, it'd have been great. You know, like it'd have been great.
I agree.
Those last few seasons got just. Mm. They're trying too hard,
and,
you know.
And that's like network TV. Right. We brought this up before, where if you want a good show like Breaking Bad, which I'm rewatching with my shorty, I've watched it before. She hasn't watched it. We're watching it again. It's fucking fantastic.
It's probably my second favorite show of all time.
They end it
with your bald eagle.
They end it right. They don't drag it out. Like we got so many fucking viewers.
Right.
Yeah. We could stretch this out for you. Let's stretch it out. Stretch it out for 4 more years. Right. No, they're like, no, this is a story. We're going to tell it.
Right.
They end it. They fucking tell the story. They end it.
Yeah.
They don't drag. The Office was great. It was popular. I don't know. It was probably one of the more popular shows
I've
on TV.
I've only seen like one or two episodes of The Office.
Really? It's good. Dude.
Yeah, that's why I didn't say anything.
It's on Netflix. No. It's on Netflix. Yeah. Yeah. Hmm.
The first four
seasons are just fucking great.
Yeah. They got great characters, great stories.
Yeah,
you really,
like
you
conflict
fuck,
resolution, yeah, sexual you, harassment. Yeah, I mean, they're all fucking great.
Michael Scott, what's his real name?
Steve Carell,
he's so good on it. A lot of the characters good on it. Right. So it is a good show. But yeah, towards the end,
it gets
just drag it out. Like, I mean, Steve Carell leaves, and then
and it got bad. It got bad. You know, they tried bringing in Will Ferrell, and they brought in James Spader.
Jim
Carrey was on an episode.
Yeah, it's like, just fucking end
just
it.
Just end it, dude.
Like, people, so.
You know, Michael Scott's gone. What's the point, you know?
No, and he
and he made the show. You know what I'm saying? He made the show.
Yeah.
So.
No, it is a good show. They just drug it out too long. But it's money. Like we said earlier in the episode, fuck bitches get money, and it's all about money.
It's all about money.
So that's what it's all about. It's not about
It's all about the birds, baby. Shit, yeah. It's all about the birds.
That's true life.
Put some respect on that.
Yeah, respect my name.
Respect my name.
Yeah, because that whole thing's respectful.
Y'all finished or y'all done? It's the same fucking thing, dude. Yeah.
We were, I don't remember where the fuck we were. We were talking to somebody.
Chuck E. Cheese?
No. And I was with JPEGs, and she's like, and I was like, yeah, and Danny's bringing a chick. And JPEGs is like,
bird.
What's he call him? And we couldn't fucking think of it. And I was just like, I was like, bird. She goes, yes, bird.
Shouts out JPEGs.
There you go.
Yeah. And she just like shook her head, like, all right, whatever. That was funny, though. That's good shit. So what are your, you guys got any other, like, shit you want to talk about for It's Always Sunny, or?
No, I think it's a great show. It's fucking hilarious.
Yeah.
I love, there's not a character in there that you don't like.
No, I absolutely not. This season, did you watch this season?
I have not, I've watched, okay, so I watched, I watched like three of the episodes. I watched when Dennis and Matt go to the suburbs.
Yeah.
I watched
the
skiing one.
Okay.
I watched that weird one where they kept going all the way back.
Frank bangs his head. Yeah, falls out the window. Yeah.
And I watched the smut film one. He made the smut. That was pretty good.
Yeah.
But that was it.
I've seen most of them.
Yeah.
What was your favorite?
This last season.
Yeah.
I really liked the fucking Dennis and Mac movie, The Suburbs.
Oh my god! Yeah. So everybody would be
with the neighbor.
Spencer.
With the neighbor.
That's one of my
up on the neighbor.
Wally.
Yeah.
I just wanted to hear your opinion.
No, I thought it was great. Yeah.
Everybody I've talked to.
The fire alarm sound. The smoke alarm sound. I heard the fucking noise the whole time.
The macaroni and cheese. Yeah. That is one of my favorite episodes of all time.
Yeah.
Everybody we talked to about it, they agreed. That was fantastic.
Yeah. But honestly, I didn't get to watch the season before that, season 10, on Netflix till about 6 months ago.
I remember talking to you about it.
Yeah, because you told me to have to watch it.
I'm like, because I remember we're at drill. Right. I'm like, oh my god, you got to watch it.
I got to watch it.
The Health Inspector,
that's a great episode.
Because Pags told me, he texted me and said, listen, did you watch the Health Inspector episode? I said, no. I said, it's recorded at home. It's like 2 days later.
Yeah.
I was working and doing other stuff. I said, I can't wait to watch it. He's like, dude, it's one of the best episodes of all time. The cinematography, the thing, everything about it. I was so excited to watch it. I watched it like 6 times. That was great. And then I remember talking about the Family Feud episode when you finally watched it.
And I thought that was fucking great. Oh, I liked their little chant. Shabuya. Shabuya. Shabuya roll call. I was dying, dude, when they did that shit. And fucking D. I eat cock. that shit was great. Just Charlie's answers.
Yeah.
When he's like, the night man. And he's like,
familiar.
That was great.
There's no other show in history where they're 10, 11 seasons deep.
Right.
And they're putting out some of their best shit.
And
that doesn't fucking happen.
And what I tell people about the show, it's 30 minutes of just chaos.
Yeah.
Every episode is 30 minutes. There's not a boring part in an episode at all.
They have, it's I hate to relate it to Seinfeld. Cause I'm not saying Seinfeld is a bad show, but it's okay. So anyway, in the episode, they got so many different things going on. In Always Sunny, somebody comes up with a plan, and everybody's like, immediately like, okay, I'm going this way with the plan. Everybody has their own intentions, and they just go with it. Nobody's dropping heat.
I like,
it may get better even.
I like Matt gets his big break. I'm a big Flyers fan, so that shit was fucking hilarious.
Dude, I just
watching him with
watched
the wig
that. I watched
and watching
it
with his Flyers jersey, you know, Charlie with the Flyers jersey out there. I thought that was great.
That episode went right at the beginning when they're talking, and then the rest of the gang is listening to it in the bar.
In the bar, right?
And then Max like, oh, what about, they're like arguing, him and Charlie arguing, and then he's like, I don't know, and he drops
Reggie
the name.
Leach. Yeah, Reggie Leach. Yeah,
and then they're like, you win.
You win.
And then Charlie goes, He screams, like puts his arms up and he screams, woo! And then it goes to the
music. Right. And you just know. Oh my you God, just dude. Know from then on it's gonna be fucking nuts. God, yep.
So good. Yep. So
and they're trying to shit on him. How is a weekend at a beach house gonna, you know? Like, yeah. How is that gonna change your life, you know?
Yeah. Oh my God, dude.
And the duster.
Yeah, the jacket. Duster. Yeah, the jacket.
Oh yeah.
Yep. For any future guests of the show, somebody bring a duster.
Oh my God, yeah.
Somebody bring a duster.
That'd be great.
That'd be great.
Yeah.
I'll be back. I'll be
back. Imagine that.
Imagine that. No, yeah.
It's good.
I fucking love it. It's one of the greatest shows.
I know, I'm glad we brought it up. Yeah. We didn't have it in our notes to bring up Always Sunny. We bring it up on every podcast, and I know how big of a fan you are.
Oh, yeah.
You're just as big of a fan as us, so I'm glad
we And I watch it late at night, you know, like at work all freaking day. So I don't get to watch this stuff till like,
for us Latino.
So I don't get to watch this shit until late at night, but I love it because it like it's late at night.
Yeah.
My roommate pulls me hear me fucking giggle like a schoolgirl, you know, because it's hilarious. You know?
I mean, it's great, and I know like
tired, but you're dying laughing watching it. You know?
There's certain people who hate because they don't watch it or whatever. Which again, you need to watch it. But we've got three people to start watching from this podcast alone. Yeah. So
that's great.
I fucking love it.
Oh my God, it's beautiful. It's so fucking good. So good.
Damn, cookies up.
We're getting faded up in this motherfucker. No bullshit. We're getting faded.
Oh shit.
Yeah. Real quick, going back to YouTube. So we brought up some old YouTube. We could bring up old YouTube forever.
Oh yeah.
One of my, like I said, like Pags or Melina will send me shit, and I'm like, oh, I know this is gonna be good. They don't send weak shit.
Yeah.
I don't know who sent me this, but it's one of my favorite videos of all time is the roller skating thug video, the English dudes.
I don't think I've seen that.
No, you've seen it, dude. Yeah, it's these black dudes, and
the two guys, and they're like. They like skate by slow. Yeah. Those guys. I know what you're talking about.
They start off the video and they're like, they're just sitting in front of like a building, and they start rapping. And he's like, and then they're like,
dudes wearing underwear.
Well, they're only filming from like the
they're
chest.
They're filming from the chest. Oh, okay. And they're like,
I'm gonna be thinking of a different video.
No,
we're gonna watch the show. This
you are. The one you're thinking about is there's like, they're filming something like not even related.
And then there's some dude that skates.
Just skates by. He's like
Superman underwear.
Yeah, it's like some type of underwear. He just like looks at the camera and just fucking skates by. So this is a totally different.
Yeah, this one. All right, so it's these three black dudes, heavy British accents. They're from like the slums of Britain, of England. And they start freestyling, you know?
Yeah.
And I don't know what they're saying. It might be good. It might be not. But they're serious as fuck.
Yeah.
And then one of the other dudes, the bigger dude, he starts rapping. And the two other dudes are like hype man now.
Yeah.
They're like, oh, shit. Yeah. And they're high-fiving and shit. And they're like, yes. And then the dude, the camera pans back. And the dude starts, he backs up and he starts fucking roller skating down the fucking street. And they start playing like Drake or whatever. And at the end of it, it says, like, roll on or get rolled over or some shit. Right. It's
the way he rolls away.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The video, it's still, this is years ago.
Right. And it's still just the way he's rolling away on the skates.
It's years ago the video came out. A couple years after that, it was on Tosh.
Right.
Still to this day, I'm like, I don't, because there's videos that you see on YouTube, and you're like, okay, is this real or is this fake or is this set up? I don't know. Like,
when I watch this, you're like, I don't know.
These dudes aren't good enough actors to like to be. They're dead serious. They're rapping. They're acting like tough.
Right.
And then like the dude, like. Raps and then rolls on roller skates. And it's,
I can't believe you haven't seen
that. Nah,
we're gonna after this podcast. We'll haven't watched it, we'll post the link to our Twitter. But it's such a good video. Right. It's so fucking good. And like that's I love it. Like you could be famous and post a video and get millions of likes, or you could just be normal
creative.
Person,
right?
And be creative. And that's the shit I like.
Right.
Like these dudes, I don't know if I don't think it's fake. Like, I don't think these guys are good enough actors to be fake. I think they're just dead fucking, serious, they're which fucking, makes it way
damn, funnier, man. Daniel!
Oh my god, yeah. Dude. But that's one of my favorite ones still.
Yeah, and that's the thing is, I don't remember, because I think you sent it to me.
And I don't know who sent it to me, man.
Yeah, that's...
oh my god, it's gold. It's gold.
Right.
A lot of times I'll send somebody, like I'll send Pags a video.
Right.
And I'll say, this is gold. Or he'll send me one and I'll reply back, gold. Like, there's gold videos, there's mediocre videos, but yeah, that's one of my favorites, man.
Yeah, dude, it's really fucking good.
Yeah.
We should look at the username. See if they, I don't know. Because like, you don't want to see what other stuff they posted because it won't be as good. Yeah, it doesn't live up. You know what I mean?
The shit Danny put us on was this African rapper. I can't remember his name. Was it?
Tunak? Kiok?
You're fading. We're all faded. Some black dude.
Tunak is the Indian guy.
It's not Tupac.
It's starting with a K.
Okay.
You know you want me to.
Yeah.
Danny brought that to the unit.
Yeah.
He's a horrible African rapper. For some reason, you can't stop watching
it. You can't stop watching it. And the best part about it is, like, you look at his backdrops he uses.
Yeah.
It's like shit from like Microsoft 94. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
And then, like, he doesn't really dance.
He doesn't really dance. He just kind of like sways. Yeah. Like a stiff, like, OG gangster move. But you start asking, like, his hat has to be Photoshopped.
Yeah.
Because the way he's wearing his hat, you're like...
it's like so high, right?
It's so like fucking high. Yeah, and like just the way it's tilted on his head, it's like, how is that motherfucker not falling off, you know? It's fucking crazy.
Yeah, it's good. Where did you hear that? Or like get that video? Did you happen to come across it?
I don't remember, man.
Yeah.
Honestly, it was a link from E-Bombs. Remember E-Bombs?
Oh, yeah, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, and somebody had sent me the link. I don't know who. It was probably one of my buddies from L.A. And sent it to me, and I just was like, oh, my God. And the title was The Greatest Rap Video Ever in History. So I knew, since it was on E-Bombs and that was the title, I knew it had to be like some 50 Tyson type shit. You know,
right,
some
right.
bogus shit. And I watched it. And I had to watch it again. And then again. Yeah. And before I sent it to anybody.
Because you go through that process in your mind. You're like, is this fake? Is he really serious? If he's really serious, I don't believe that either.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, you start going through that in your head.
Well, you produce a music video like that. It's like, obviously he didn't do it by himself. Or if he did, props to him. But it's like, if someone else produced that video... why isn't anybody saying anything? Like, you know, like, hey, dog, I'd probably hold off on releasing this video. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Right? You know?
Yeah, that's the same thing with, like, the roller skating, dude.
Right,
it's like,
you
got to be serious or you got to be a great actor.
I can't believe you've never
seen
that, man.
No, I'll have to watch it.
Oh, my God.
We'll watch it right after this.
Yeah, for sure.
I'll have to watch shit up here, but... that's fucking, it's beautiful, man.
That's
fucking
great.
We'll post links. After this podcast, we got a couple things we'll post, including some of the links to the videos we're talking about, some of the pictures we're talking about. man. I think it's been fucking great. It's been a blast. I don't know if it's been entertaining to listen to. Fuck it.
I don't give a fuck about you. It's been a lot of fun. Y'all listening? Shut the shit off. That's good. For everybody listening out there, keep listening. Spicy and Pag Nasty got a good thing going here. This is legit. Like, you guys got sound equipment. You know what I'm saying? You guys, you know, like, this is keeping everybody together. So,
thanks, man.
Yeah, just make sure you support. I still got to get a T-shirt, man. I've been lacking on that shit.
You're spending money going on flights, pushing flights back. You haven't bought a T-shirt. Hey, you son of a bitch.
That's it. You should have got the shit and took it back. Mom, this is what I was doing.
Work for your family pictures.
Yes.
That'd be great.
A piece of chicken.
Yeah. I got extra shirt in my closet, dog. After this, I'm gonna hook you up.
There you go.
I'll hook you up.
Yeah. No, seriously. It's been fucking awesome.
Yeah, it's been
great. I can't wait to be back.
Oh, no, yeah. You'll be back.
Yeah, we got more stories to tell.
Oh, we got a lot of stories.
Yeah.
Dude, thanks for the gifts, man.
Like, oh,
when we invite people on the podcast,
yeah,
we invite people that we really enjoy being with. Like I said before, right. Both of you guys are two of the funniest motherfuckers I know. So I know no matter what, I'm going to have a lot of fun and laugh. Yeah. When you bring gifts, and especially gifts like you brought, like the German cake with fried chicken on top of it was one of the best gifts I've ever had. It's fucking great. We will post pictures of that on the gram later. Yeah.
On the gram. Add me on the gram too for everybody out there, all the birds out there. If you're a pigeon, I want nothing to do with you. I'm trying to, you know, just don't add me. You know? No, I'm just kidding. Skywalker _86, add me. I really don't get on Twitter much.
No, you don't have much Twitter. Instagram, though, you blow up.
I blow up my Instagram all the time. I post all a bunch of petty shit.
No, I fucking love it. No, if you're in a trying to exercise, if you're into getting into fighting, boxing, MMA, our boy here, he's a funny dude, but he's also legit. He's a businessman. He knows what he's doing. Get at us. We'll hook you up with them. If you want to plug any of your businesses, do it, man.
Anything on social media, just like Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter, just hashtag search Skywalker 101. It'll bring up pictures, videos, everything from my boxing academy I run, all the fighters I train, all the non-competitors I train. I train boxers, MMA fighters, Muay Thai fighters, kickboxing fighters. And I have a location in Papillion. I work all day, do personals with people. So if you're looking to get in shape, or you're looking just to learn some self-defense or whatever, and because the thought of a boxing gym, people think it's really intimidating.
Right.
Because you think boxing gym, the first thing people think is, man, I want to get punched in the face. You know, my environment that I create and shit, I do all one-on-ones, personal one-on-ones. So people come in, it's me and them. I turn the music up, I turn the heat up, and we just have fun. We work out, we have fun. I teach you the basics of boxing. And like I said, I teach everybody from, I got a 13-year-old kid that's in middle school that's been bullied, who's got, autism, but he's one of the coolest kids in the world. And then I got like business owners that, 50 years old that own businesses that just, they want to learn something they never learned before. So all walks of life. I love my job. I love my homies. I love being here. So like I said, hashtag search Skywalker 101. You'll find plenty of stuff. And if you're in the Omaha area looking to, try something new, just hit me up.
Yeah. A couple weeks ago, Danny calls me up. He's like, hey, man, what are you doing tonight? I got tickets for you if you want to go see the fights. I said, let me check with Camus. We'll call her up. She's like, yeah, we could go. Let's do it. We go to the fights. Danny gave me free seats. We got to see Danny coach. Danny do his thing at the arena.
All his peeps lost.
Yeah.
Hey, that night was crazy. One of my guys. I think I went 2-2 that night. I didn't do too bad.
Yeah.
I went 2-2. One of my guys, he's at a point in his career where he's like getting close to being pro. When you're getting close to being pro on the amateur side, and it's more about the fights you take. It's not just about winning. It's about getting the toughest fight out there to see if you're ready to go pro.
Right.
So he's lost two in a row, but the two fights that he's lost against, the fighters he lost against, are some of the toughest amateurs in the country at the amateur level. Yeah. So, and he took them the distance. So I told him, there's nothing to hang your head about. You may have lost, but you didn't lose. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Exactly. Sure. Yeah. So I matched him up against a kid who was 4-0, who had all first round finishes. And so I knew he wasn't intimidated by all means. But I told him, hey, these are the kind of fights you're going to have to take. And you start winning these kind of fights, that's when we think about going pro. And this dude was in the gym every day. He was doing his personals. He was going to jiu-jitsu practice. He was doing his strength and conditioning. And what happens? My guy goes out there. He knees the piss out of this dude. Pops 3 teeth out of his mouth. Hits him with a standing guillotine. Done. 50 seconds.
Nice.
Yes. Yeah.
Hell yeah.
And it was just because he trained hard. Yeah. You know, I just guided him. I didn't do anything special. Right. You know. And so, Spicy came out to the fights.
Yeah.
He brought his bird with him.
The bald eagle.
Yeah. He's bald eagle. Yeah. Shout out to Victory Fighting Championships. They're located here in Omaha. We got good things going. We're on UFC Fight Pass. One of my best friends, Ryan Stoddard, he owns the promotion. He's doing a lot of hard work, getting Omaha on the map and their local fighters. So I'm really blessed to have the opportunity for my fighters to have like one of the best platforms in the country to show their skills, and only like makes me look better, you know?
Oh, for sure.
So,
like I said, from my perspective, Danny fucking hooked us up. We came out, he did good. I remember seeing that fight that finished with the standing guillotine, and I remember thinking, what's going on in the ring? Yeah, the old boy lost. I was looking for his teeth. And I'm like, okay,
Danny came. I was like, damn, that bites.
God damn it.
and we had a table, and I was sitting with some of the other fighters that Danny trains with, and they had nothing but good things to say about Danny and me, of course, and nothing but bad things to say about Danny. Scumbags. I told them all the bad stories, the Buddy Holly story. Yeah, buddy. Like, watch out who's training you. This motherfucker's crazy as fuck.
Bleach is his
Danny,
asshole.
Yeah. I mean, it tastes good, but like, it looks weird.
Yeah. Everything else is brown butter's butt.
Yeah, like, it's not natural, man. Dude, just keep it real. Disgusting. Keep it real, dog. Yeah. I'm just being real.
It looks like a bowl of ice cream.
Yeah, it tastes fine. It just looks fucked up.
Yeah, you guys keep sending in our questions. We're going to record some more here, so we should have a couple of these podcasts for a couple weeks for you. So we definitely need questions for our next one. Again, just send them to nastyandfriends@gmail.com. Twitter, Instagram, nastyandfriends. Anything else before we sign off here?
I'm not surprised, motherfuckers.
I just want to say, like real quick, when we started off, it was just about friends talking, and that's what this is.
Yeah.
But when I have people come up to me and say they enjoy the podcast, or people like rocking our gear or whatever, like, it means a fucking lot. Like, we appreciate everybody that shows respect, listens, enjoys it. It's just for fun. We're not like we're never gonna get famous. We're not making any money off of this.
I'm broke.
We're just having fun. But even when people are like, "Hey, man, the shit you said about this, like, I fucking rewinded it and laughed or whatever," like, that means a lot. Like, thanks for everybody who's supporting us.
For sure.
For real. That's all I got to say. It's all love.
Yeah, absolutely. Again, thanks, guys, and buy some gear again if you want. Take pictures, tag us. We'll get it out there. And again, send in your questions.
Send questions and send titty pics.
Send nudes.
Remember, guys, life's simple. Don't be a dick. Night, sluts.